Hey, welcome to another episode of Grab Bag. We have some illustrious guests here. We're gonna do some crazy stuff with some crazy games. I think y'all have been here. I don't gotta explain it too much, but basically we're gonna take these games, take some elements of them, mash them up, see what we can come up with, and you know, hopefully it's not a complete failure. You never really know. So let's see what happens this week. I don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know what's gonna happen. We don't know what's gonna happen. We'll see what the hell is gonna happen.
This is gonna happen.
Yeah, let me have you start by introducing yourselves and what you do and how you got here and we got to plug.
All right, my name is Chris Rollins. I work at a brick and mortar store called Card Kingdom here in Seattle, Washington. I'm the media production coordinator there. I also design games and host a tabletop games podcast called NPC Cast. My publishing company is called 1000XP. We have a YouTube channel where we do like game design videos and that kind of stuff. Super excited. Haven't played these. Love this. So we'll see what happens.
Hi, I'm Nicole Jekic. I write about board games and a lot of Kickstarter games on acrosstheboardgames.net. I also do a lot of community building through Playtest Northwest and basically playtest games by local designers around the Seattle area. And I'm also working on a game with my partner Luke that's all about food trucks, and we also play that at Playtest Northwest.
I'm Isaias Vallejo. I am a co-owner for Daily Magic Games. I am also the designer for Valeria Card Kingdoms and co-designer for Villages of Valeria. We have a new Kickstarter going out next Tuesday for Quests of Valeria, so we're all in on this Valeria stuff. But yeah, it's me and David McKenzie and Levi Moat and Sarah Sharp. We're the Daily Magic team, and we also started Playtest Northwest just to showcase all of the awesome designers we have here in the Pacific Northwest.
Awesome, cool. Thanks y'all for joining us, joining us.
Everyone
on this crazy show. I already know a couple people Lachy's in the chat too. I've been there, awesome. I know Rough Dreamer, she's the one that got me on the show.
Cool. Well, everyone's helping everyone around here, I like it.
Yeah.
If you haven't seen the show, I'm assuming most of you have, what we're gonna do is take these games, mush them up. We start with y'all actually have picked these games, and we're gonna use predetermined elements from each game. So from X-Wing, Star Wars X-Wing, we're gonna use the figures. From Risk, Game of Thrones, we're gonna use the board. And from Archer, we're gonna use the cards. I believe that's correct. And see what we can do. We got about 2 hours to make a game. We'll try and make it functional, and then we'll have a squad of randos walk in here, and we'll teach them how to play it, and it's gonna be awesome. So let's open this stuff up. See what the hell is in here, and see what y'all think.
So I'm super intrigued to see the Archer cards, because I've never played the game before.
Okay.
And I know cards can have art on them, they can have text on them, and so we'll see what happens from there.
Yeah, I know that there's a lot of character art. This is a Cryptozoics game, and they're always known for doing really good IPs with a lot of art. A lot of good art. So let's see, cards.
This is the Game of Thrones board.
That board is no joke.
Yeah,
it's let's get the board here. It's in the center.
I feel like we're definitely gonna put all stuff on it.
I've seen the first season of Game of Thrones, so no spoilers in chat, please.
Okay.
I'm sure all my favorite characters live the entire time. Yeah,
so. You can put all the spoilers you want for me, because I will not watch that show, I'm sorry. Ooh, there's even a map in the board.
Oh, there's two boards.
This is madness.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
All right.
Do we have to use both boards?
Well, let's see what this other board is. Is it the same thing? No, not the same thing.
Westeros.
Is there? Oh, there's two continents.
Yeah, there's two continents.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, I think we're gonna do some plane switching. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Okay. This is unprecedented.
So it goes like this, doesn't it?
Is there north south?
Anybody want to help out here?
Yeah,
no, because this is our world. This is not. Oh, this is not. Right, George R. R. Martin sucks.
Right. You're right.
He's taking too long. We're gonna do what we want. So we just have to use the minis, I think.
Yeah, you just have to use, I mean, that's the requirement. You can use a little extra if you want to use these crazy, whatever the hell these things are.
The flight path.
Yeah, they're the movements.
Oh, okay.
Movement
yeah, use those.
Very, very specific.
Who doesn't need a flight path from time to time? And if there's extra stuff in any of those boxes, feel free to use that. We just have the minimum requirements of cards, boards, and the figures.
Okay. So let's do like a little a sort of inventory of what we have. So for the X-Wing, we have to use three miniatures. There's two TIE Fighter minis
okay.
and an X-Wing mini.
That's it?
Just in the base set. Yeah, it's Fantasy Flight. Yeah, so you actually have to buy like two base sets to really get the full experience. Fantasy Flight.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. You get a lot of box with this game.
We have a couple weird little twister things here too, if you want
to there's dials and there's all sorts of stuff in there that we can actually use. Then we have this massive board, which I'm assuming we can probably use one side if we decide we want to use it. But I think that in the spirit of the challenge, we should probably go all out.
Try to use both.
Hard mode.
You want to tell the whole game of all the thrones.
Okay.
And then we have the cards too. So you want to show some of those? I don't know.
Oh yeah. So I I've never seen this game before, but I am kind of familiar with at least the first five seasons of Archer. Mm. And there's ego boosts and insults. It looks like happen. So we can throughout this game we can call each other idiots.
Danger zone.
Danger zone. Yeah, we're gonna be singing a lot of danger zone. So I hope everyone has their Kenny Loggins ready. Yeah.
Perfect.
Oh man, that's a lot of archers. Okay, so is that.
So whatever we end up with, can we just make sure that we're flying these TIE fighters and stuff around conquering territory? I think that's like the easiest thing.
Those could maybe be the player, represent the players, or whatever you want to be.
There are three of us.
Yeah, there's three.
Okay, so this is going to be a game where there's one v2.
Okay.
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 Easy enough.
Okay, not
I like
it.
That.
All right.
Yeah.
Not it.
Oh,
I'll be it.
All right, Isaiah. So me and Nicole will be.
All right.
We're not playing yet.
No, we? I know. I'm just kind of to get the the mindset.
We're drawing a line already.
Chad is asking what the buzzer is for. Vanderlees asks, well, if these kids get a little riled up and they can't focus, I want to buzz them.
I
want to buzz them. It's been there in previous episodes. I just never got around to using it. So
hopefully you won't use it this time. It's possible though.
I might just use it. Just
although it does have like. That could be included in this game.
Sure.
Oh, actually, that sounds great.
Oh, well, okay. Lasers. You're getting crazy with this.
I'm
like
just saying,
that.
Potentially, right?
No, sure,
because
I'm down with that.
There is the wheel.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we've explained that
Oh,
yet.
Damn it! I forgot to explain the wheel.
Right.
Thank you so much.
No worries.
Okay, so, can someone prep a camera on the wheel? We are introducing this week, totally forgot, a crazy, crazy mechanic, as explained, outlined over here. We have this spinny wheelie. I don't know what the real proper name of these wheel things are, but if anyone donates $25 or more, we are going to spin this crazy ass wheel. I hope there's a camera on it. I can't quite tell.
Stand by the wheel, Dan. Go stand by the wheel.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll stand by the damn wheel. I can do that. Okay. So here's how the wheel works. Okay. You donate $25 or more, we'll spin this crazy wheel. It's got all kinds of stuff on there, like add a rule. Add a love interest, add or remove currency. Someone has to communicate using pens only. Someone has to wear the Sharky suit. So on and so forth. They're all, silly weirdo rules. And donate some money, we'll spin this wheel. Whatever pops up, someone's gonna be, mildly inconvenienced for a little while. So yeah, that's a new thing we added. Donate away, we'll see. I have no idea how it's gonna work out. It's probably gonna be chaos, so. we'll see how that goes. I'm not scared. It's a welcome challenge.
Yeah, so I'm going through these cards and sorting them because it basically kind of looks like there's decks for individual characters of the show.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we'll mess those up later, probably, because that's kind of the name of the game, mm-hmm. but. For right now, we'll kind of get all the characters their own packs.
How many characters are in this show? It's like a million.
Well, it's like
15.
It's like.
I don't know.
It's like an office. It's kind of like an office space level of people, and these are most of the main characters.
So I think we have the components out.
Seven
characters. I think what we should do is figure out the object of the game.
Okay.
A lot of times when you're like designing games. The rules are all basically impediments to say, your goal is to do this, but we're going to put all these rules in your way to stop you from doing that. And that's where the fun of the game comes from.
Okay.
So we have this game, we've decided it's 2v1. Mm-hmm. It's one of those, one of those three player games that everyone loves so much.
Right.
Has to be played with three, only three, no more, no less.
Mm-hmm.
So what is the goal? Like, this is our continent, this is your continent.
Yeah.
What is happening here? Why are we in conflict? What's going on?
I think we should probably do some area control stuff, area majority.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So right now I'm thinking we gotta move around and we gotta probably not just attack each other because that's gonna be boring if we're just rolling dice back and forth, but actually maybe dropping off characters or picking up characters.
Yeah, maybe we're fighting over these characters or something. Maybe it's not people that these aren't people that we play. They're maybe people that we're fighting over, and yeah, like either have to deliver or something like that.
So we, maybe these are people that are like lost. These are heroes that have been lost somewhere in these two continents.
Okay.
And yeah, I think that that would be a way for us to incentivize moving around and not necessarily get into direct conflict. Mm-hmm. And then from there, we can determine, you know, why they're lost and why we need to find them, mm-hmm. and why it's us, our nation versus this the massive rebellion. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It could be something where, you know, some of us are actually trying to help these lost people versus not helping them or doing something different.
The rebellion is trying to find where we've hidden these captured spies.
Okay.
Oh, there you go.
These captured archers.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And the empire of, what is this? What is this continent? The Stormland? Whatever this is called. I don't know. This continent, we have...
Westeros.
This is Westeros?
Yeah.
This is Easteros? Is that...
No. Which way are we facing? Southeros.
I think this is the lands beyond the wall is what it is, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I give up.
If anyone has seen this show, it has fans, I know.
Yeah, tell us.
Yeah.
Let us know.
Somebody's gotta know.
So in Westeros, we've hidden some of these characters. This player is trying to sneak into these lands to free these characters in the meantime.
That was quick.
Yeah, already straight.
Alright, so we got spin, right?
Wait 1 second.
Hash said or dash crook hopes for big bucks, no whammies.
Alright, thank you so much for that donation. I think that was a wow fear, I believe. Let's spin this damn wheel. I'm kind of scared. You don't want to? Okay,
spin
the damn wheel. Spin the damn wheel. Oh man, these are all freaky deaky. Okay, here we go. That was a healthy spin. That's good. Okay, we have a zombie Galactus entering the game.
Someone in there wanted zombie Galactus.
Yeah. Okay, we have to incorporate this.
Okay.
Easy.
Not that bad. Okay.
Easy. All right. I was actually already picturing Galactus. I'm glad it came up that way.
Okay, yeah. We have a zombie Galactus.
And zombie Galactus totally has to like eat things, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
that's what he does.
All right, so we have to do something before he eats these people.
Right, so Galactus and his army of TIE fighters is trying to crush the rebellion, and he's going to move from the top of, I think someone said this is Hither 4-2, so this is Hither 4-2, and he's going to move from the top and move down, and while he's going, if this player has not freed these rebels, he is going to consume them, and then they're going to be lost forever. Okay. If he ever consumes more rebels, then this person can free. So I think we have 7, right?
Is that what but how are you going to assign these cards as rebels on the board if the spots are so small?
Are there chits in?
Oh, there is.
Hey.
There you go.
Yeah.
Look at that, solving problems.
I don't know how we can use these. There's 8 rebels though. Archer is not a rebel though, right? He's like the hero.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So I'll be Archer.
Okay,
you can be Archer. Oh boy. All right.
In my X-Wing.
All right. Archer in his X-Wing is trying to come over here and take out these rebels. Now this player, in the meantime, is trying to come over to this area, not Westeros, opposite of Westeros, and they're trying to deprive you of resources.
Okay.
So it's an asymmetrical thing. You are searching these lands trying to free rebels. We are trying to mess with you and take out your resources so that you're not able to find the rebels in time and distract you while what's his name? Galactus?
Zombie
Galactus is moving across the lands, consuming.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sounds good. We also have should I write any of that down or we got it all?
Nah.
Okay.
We can use the whiteboard for something.
So this seems pretty tough for our X-Wing player, huh?
Yeah.
It would be.
Yeah,
he's gonna be severely OP, don't worry about it.
Okay.
Yeah, now we have to figure out how to make Isaiah's OP.
So this is a huge issue. Normally it's very difficult to balance asymmetrical goals that are so completely opposed to one another.
Right, yeah.
And that's normally when you have plenty of time.
Okay.
We have a little bit less.
Yeah.
Like our dev cycle is a little bit shorter than the traditional board game. Mm-hmm. So that's gonna be one of the issues that we're gonna be facing, I think, moving in here. I'm also noticing that these chits, they have their faces on both sides.
Right.
So what we need to do is the Game of Thrones,
they have those things over there on the table.
Okay. We also have to figure out what happened.
I'm trying to match all my outfits with these damn chips.
We had white chips too, right?
We do have white chips.
We're gonna put the white chips. We're gonna draw on both.
Okay.
These are dry erases. These might just come off and then the whole game will fall apart.
Perfect.
I think that's a production issue that we'll have to deal with.
We'll have your show, Dan. I just live in it.
Oh, okay. We're just burning our blue chip budget right now.
Blue chips. That's a
we
Nick
need
Nolte
another
now.
Donation so that you can buy more blue
another
chips.
Donation so we can buy more blue chips. That's what it is.
Or maybe, I don't know, red chips.
If we can get rainbow
too,
chips in here, that'd
that's
be great.
Too fancy.
I'm trying to match all my outfits with these damn chips.
Okay. We have white chips too, right?
We do have white chips.
We're gonna put the white chips. We're gonna draw on both.
Okay.
These are dry erases. These might just come off and then the whole game will fall apart.
Perfect.
I think that's a production issue that we'll have to deal with.
We'll refine that in the second edition of the game.
Arbitrarily decided that there's gonna be 10 chips,
okay.
Only 7 spies.
Okay.
So some of the chips are red herrings, of course.
Okay.
Right. Got it.
Chris with the mechanics.
And then,
he's done this before.
They're just coming out.
You're
coming out.
Hide the chips on the map, and I have to guess. But then I have to say, like, I'm hunting for Krieger.
No. I think you're gonna find whoever you find.
Okay.
And then that's gonna give you their access to their power ups.
Okay.
So for example, Pam has insults, and it says you're ruining.
They all have insults.
Right? Oh really?
Oh yeah. Plenty of insults.
Oh my god.
Oh, so all the cards are insults.
Who taught you how to punch? Your husband?
Okay.
Oh yeah, that one's great.
I, for one, am going to watch Hooper until my fingers bleed.
This one just says you suck. That's pretty hard to the point.
Very useful.
Yeah. So we need to figure out a way for these to influence the gameplay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Is there any ideas that you guys have on how these cards that do not have numbers on them can influence or act as resources?
Hmm.
Are all they have their ego boosts, insults, and double ego boosts? So ego boosts to me, maybe like this ship runs on ego.
Mm-hmm.
So you need an ego.
It's
Archer. So ego boosts allow you to move farther.
Okay.
Double ego boost,
twice as far.
That's just fuel.
This is math, dude. Yeah. Come on.
Oh wait. So what if we have insults? So we can hurl insults at you, to the VR attack.
Okay.
Oh. All right. So we need someone to sort these. Can you help us sort these?
Sure.
So let's get rid of the. We're gonna put the insults in one pile.
Okay.
And the ego boosts and double ego boosts in another pile.
Okay. Should I mix the double ego boost with the ego boost?
Yeah, that's fine. And then there's other ones that have, if none of your foes have the same amount of upper hand as you, draw an event card.
Some of them are conditional.
Keep those with the boosts.
Keep the conditional ones with the boosts.
Yes. Because as the rebel player is finding, like when the rebel player finds Rey, we have a whole bunch of insults that we can now use against Rey. You see what I'm saying?
Okay. That were specific to the individual character.
So as the rebel player is going through and finding these characters, they're also going to be inadvertently powering up Zombie Galactus's TIE Fighter army.
Okay. Got it.
Okay.
All right.
Wow.
So we're stacking all the deck against you. We're going to have to figure out a way to balance this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but we still have all these events and stuff that happen, plus challenges. Well,
we don't have to use every single card.
No.
But it couldn't hurt. It couldn't hurt.
I mean, it just depends on how much of a wuss you want to appear in front of the entire internet.
There you go.
Yeah.
So,
no, you're right.
I'll leave that up to you.
So I'm a big wuss, and I'm okay with that.
Okay.
These have numbers on them.
Do you want to keep the insults sorted by character?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
This is going to be a Fantasy Flight game, so there's going to be a million decks.
There are a million damn decks right now. This is
right.
True.
There's ego decks.
That's true. So
yeah, he feels me.
You have to pay $5 for each little stack.
And actually, if we were really doing it, we could just cut it in half, and then it would be even more Fantasy Flight, just all the half cards.
Oh, I was going to say, I thought you were making a Legacy game.
Oh.
Just randomly, you just cut cards in half, and then it's a Legacy game.
Oh, yeah, there you go. And then we'll be back tomorrow, or not playing the same game and how it evolved, right?
Perfect.
Yeah.
I figured the whole week.
Yeah,
I mixed all these chips up.
We're gonna see. Someone mentioned earlier. I don't think any of us have seen Game of Thrones out of all three of us.
I watch it. I'm just bad at. I have bad memory.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
I watched the first season.
Yeah, I'm not.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not
Krieger.
That big a nerd.
Okay.
I'm a nerd. I don't commit stuff to memory.
Okay. Cool. Well, we're gonna make our own story of what goes on here.
Let's do this. We're gonna have. Put them like this. In that Game of Thrones box, is there a way to figure out these location to randomize these areas?
Uh huh.
We need a D20. We need someone to donate $25, and then we need to roll the D20. Because that would actually really help us out.
There's a bunch of
dice. We're probably just going to get a shark suit.
Oh, perfect.
Okay, we have dice. All
right. Well, we can't use a D20, though, right? Is there anyone in there?
There's no D20.
We got to save that. So we still need help from the viewers for that, but we'll see how far we can get.
All right. I don't know if you still want the white chips, but I can't open them, so someone
else. Cool. That's a design flaw.
There's a lot going on over here. Okay.
Yeah, there's... We got Cyril. Everyone loves Cyril. Let's see.
Cyril Figgis?
I'll say that y'all came up with a game structure very quickly.
Is that faster than normal?
Oh, that's way faster than
normal. Holy shit, that scares me actually. Yeah. That's really bad. Because you've had some really big designers who are like professional in the industry for a long time.
That's true. But you know,
let's scrap it.
Forget it. No, you know, every set of elements we give them is a different difficulty level. Mm-hmm. And we don't quite know what that's going to be until they show up and start poking around.
Oh, I see. So when you said
the easy mode.
Right.
Well, we haven't built the game yet, but I feel like we're headed in a real solid direction right now.
When you saw us coming, you're like, what's the easiest thing we can do? Game of Thrones board, Archer cards, X-Wing minis, Zombie Galactus, Wheel of Doom.
We had a theme, and we wanted to stick with it. Yeah. Trying to stay consistent around here.
Okay. So, first of all, we're attacking, we're fighting, you get D8s, we get D6s.
Yeah, that's a no-brainer.
No, that's simple, right? And we're doing that because we've already decided that's going to be really hard for the Rebels to win.
3d6s.
3d6. And you get 3d8?
48.
Wait, trying to make but if there's two of us, don't I get a set of d6s?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Come on, Isaiah. Don't hold that on us. Oh.
That's all there is.
So the TIE Fighters have d6s. Uh-huh. The X-Wing, which is supposed to be a little stronger, will have the d8s.
Right.
And more of them.
And we'll try to figure out a way for that combat mechanic to work. We don't know that yet. We know that it will involve dice.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But the game is not all about combat. You can't open it either?
Yeah. We're just going to keep passing it down.
It's like welded shit, so.
How did you?
Oh, it's because you work for a game store.
Yeah, that's right. Card Kingdom. You come to Card Kingdom, we'll open everything you own. No problem. It's one of the services we offer.
Yeah.
We just need 1 through 7 on this. I don't know where the markers went.
Oh, I put them back.
Thank you.
Let's see. Do we want the ego boost separate, or are those all going to Isaiah?
So the ego boosts are what Isaiah is gonna, when Isaiah frees Cyril.
Free Cyril.
Yeah. He will get Cyril's ego boosts.
Okay.
We will get Cyril's insults added to our insult deck.
Ah. Okay.
So that we can. So when he uses a Cyril ego boost, we can instead insult Cyril to say that it's not going to power your ship. Right. You're not going to get that.
Did you make this into a deck building game with that just now?
No, you just did though.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's like, yeah. Now we're doing that.
Now we have a deck building board something
which
game.
Which means we must have a hand limit, so we can't just like keep all the cards and
this
all the
insults.
This
is insane.
Hand limit. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's a good idea.
All right, so how are we going to set these people on?
Okay.
What are you doing right now?
So right now I have chips.
He's looking busy, right? We should just be doing that too.
We should just be writing stuff. Why are you not writing shit on shit, guys?
Just looking.
There you go. Now we're busy.
No. So Isaiah, here's where we go. We're gonna have we need the character illustrations. You're writing this down?
I'm writing it down.
There's Sarah. Okay. Oh, sorry.
So each character is gonna randomly get a number associated with them.
Mm-hmm.
You have your little chits over there, you're working that out?
Yeah.
Get the faces. So put the face next to the one.
Each, right?
Yeah, like bullpen is next to the one. Is that his name?
This is gonna take a while.
Oh,
no, that's not his name.
This board is huge.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's true.
The bigger the board, the more the fun.
Also, one thing I forgot to mention, and you can just keep this kind of churning in the back of your mind, we need to think of a snappy game name at the end of this.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So
that's not Danger Zone.
Just be
even
open.
Even though that would be really great.
That would be great.
A snappy name. Yeah, I think we're gonna have to defer to the chat on that. I can't process all of this.
There are some good suggestions.
Mm-hmm. I like puns. If anyone
Westeros
can think of a
Trail.
Westeros Trail.
The Westeros Trail.
If anyone can think of anything with puns, I really like puns.
Yeah, everyone does.
Yeah.
There's not a single person in the world that just doesn't enjoy them.
Well, no. Well, I've met those people, and they're no fun.
The internet likes puns. We'll say that.
In general.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you for agreeing with me.
You know, I'm trying. I'm trying to be agreeable. That's all I do.
You know, we could have made this a 2-on-2 game. We could have, like, we didn't even think about that.
Oh, no, it's fine.
Oh, but we only have 3 minis.
Mm-hmm.
We have 4 now.
Unless you have it, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, do you want to control Zombie Galactus?
Is
that a player character?
You know, I've often considered myself a Zombie Galactus in my pastime.
All right.
So yeah, I'll do that.
Now you can live the dream.
I can try.
So basically, that $25 basically unlocked a stretch goal, which is a fourth player expansion, which was the zombie apocalypse expansion.
The zombie apocalypse expansion.
So there's only six characters because Archer was a seventh.
Get rid of that seven. It's easy. Look at this. We're cutting stuff out. This is what pro designers are doing.
Yeah, because you always start with too much
pro
stuff.
Pro designers.
Okay.
Danger Thrones.
Who's
Danger Thrones?
Oh, Slappy, man, Danger Thrones.
That's really good. Man.
Okay, so there's something that we do. I didn't coin the phrase, but it's called playstorming. And that's when you just start putting stuff out and moving things around to give you an idea of where the game's going to go. It's like brainstorming, but playtesting, right?
Okay.
So I'm just going to start setting stuff up to give us an indication of what we might be looking at.
Mm-hmm.
So we have on this side of the board, we have the spies,
the people.
1 through 6.
Mm-hmm.
So these are 1 through 6, right? We'll take these, turn them face down, mix them all up.
Need a whole bunch of blanks or no?
No, I have some blanks here.
Okay.
Now we would need to figure out a way to randomize these across, what is this, Westeros?
Mm-hmm.
Do we know if there's actually locations in the Game of Thrones
there's
box
probably
somewhere?
In the deck of cards or something.
There are a lot of
cards.
Are
those unopened?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I feel special. I'm assuming that there's going to be, so we're just going to start putting stuff. Actually, how many of these?
You want to put them on these?
There's a lot more continent, country, cities, states, whatever these are, everywhere.
You could just have them on the capitals of each of these colored country bits, right? Are there enough? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
There's
eight,
more.
Eight.
Oh, wait.
These do not have those easy to peel things on there.
Okay.
It's just bad.
So we have,
one
so.
One there, like that, something like that. I don't know.
All right.
That's random. I like
so that. We'll put them out like that. So we're assuming that we're hopefully going to have found a way to randomize that.
Sure.
What is this? Zombie Galactus. Mm-hmm. I called them Zombie Apocalypse earlier.
That works too.
So
yeah.
Zombie Galactus starts in Skagos, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
And each turn they're going to move one space close.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to start unleashing spies.
Okay.
In the meantime, we have the Rebel player here. Is going to be flying around the areas trying to find the spies that they're associated with.
Right.
Okay? And these players are trying to stop them.
Okay. So how do we stop them if we don't have any insults to throw to start?
I'm assuming that's a rhetorical question and you're going to answer it right now.
We're going to start with some cards first. So we have some basic insults. Okay, we have basic insults
okay.
to throw. All right.
And as far as moving on the board, are you just kind of moving continent area to continent area, or is it kind of like
we're flying?
Space,
I feel like we can. I don't know. Just go
X
different places.
Inches or whatever. There we go.
Okay. So we have the.
So, but we're not using the actual territories.
Well, we can use the territories.
I think that's a simple thing.
The question is that what is happening? Like, if all the action is taking place over here,
mm-hmm.
what is happening with this?
Yeah.
With this board over here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh.
That's a tough thing.
Mm-hmm. We have a whole bunch of other cards. There could be just like events or things happening.
We're using the cards from Archer, but we also have, oh, there's men in the Game of Thrones.
There's figures in there, you can use those, sure. You could have, okay, here's an idea.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we take turns in a round. So, no, that doesn't make sense. I was gonna say, so this guy has two turns, whereas this guy gets this team gets one turn.
Mm-hmm.
So then he can, because he's gonna be doing a lot of stuff, and maybe they're trying to run over to that continent, and he's trying to save people. They're trying to maybe fuck shit up over there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maybe. I mean, I don't know. That's just an idea.
Yeah. Like, what if we just ignore the fact that this has a vent on it, and maybe they're like fire tokens or something? Maybe I'm actually like burning this place up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Yeah, but you're gonna lose track because they're too big.
You can use
I can count how many fires.
Oh. You can use the white, the white tokens.
We have white tokens too.
Or the figures,
we have white tokens.
Whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
the white tokens, okay.
The question that I'm wondering though is like, we're gonna have this system up here of freeing spies. Maybe we actually need to spread this out. Maybe the spies are actually all over.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That would make more sense. Then we actually are using more of the board, mm-hmm. right? So I'm just gonna take some over here.
Someone's telling us that this is for book two and we shouldn't worry about it.
I like that suggestion.
For book two?
Right.
It just makes sense in the terms of the show.
This is where all the dragon stuff.
I think that was more sarcastic than...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is an expansion,
mm-hmm.
maybe?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right.
We could just put a whole bunch of blank ones on here and then have them be other things. Or maybe these guys have like evil twins, so that way you have multiples of these spies going around.
Evil twins, yeah.
Because I mean, we do have a lot of cards for all these different characters.
We do.
It'd be weird to just have it be.
I like the idea of having them count as other things, though. Because if we're turning this into like, let's say we're turning this into a bigger war game, right? Mm-hmm. A war game of thrones. And
Danger Thrones.
A war game of Danger Thrones. And we have, this is our most powerful, these are our commanders, these are our most powerful pieces. Mm-hmm. But we could use the other pieces to move around and actually do some of the exploring.
Okay.
It was just that maybe these move faster. Mm-hmm. So whereas like...
I was thinking like, there's some of these that have ports, right? Mm-hmm. So maybe my guy has the ability to teleport from these ports to any other port.
Mm-hmm. Except the ports, are you fine with it? The ports are only on here though.
So those are there too.
Oh, they're just not blue.
Mm-hmm.
This would be a lot easier if we just got rid of this board.
It would. That's what I was saying.
I think that's totally fine.
Cutting the board.
There's a lot of board. I made an executive decision.
Sorry. Maybe if someone wants to donate $25 more, we'll add another.
Don't throw that.
Isaiah doesn't want to.
All right.
Okay.
Should we turn it horizontally, maybe?
Sure.
Well, no.
Leave it
like that.
Leave it like this?
Yeah, because we need space for this, and then we need space for all the
cards. Leave it canted.
Okay. All right. So you have to make the difficult decisions.
Mm-hmm.
And we did that.
Sometimes simpler is better.
All right.
Okay.
So now we have a simple process. So we have Zombie Galactus starts there.
Yeah.
You start down here in one. Mm-hmm. Oh, they're all ones. My bad. Whatever. You start down there.
At the bottom. Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
And
that's
cold. I'm looking for them.
And he's trying to move through. The problem with Zombie Galactus starting here is that he's just going to eat. There's no way that he's going to get this far.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you both want to start over there and then it's a race.
Yes.
Yeah.
I like that.
And he doesn't affect me, is what you're saying?
Mm-hmm. Maybe he does, yeah.
He's
maybe
too big and slow.
He doesn't eat you.
Yeah, you're too fast.
Right. Okay.
Let's see.
So it's really like a one versus three, huh?
Oh.
It kind of is.
Wish we could incorporate pandemic elements. Ooh.
Yeah. Oh. I wish we could too.
Yeah. How do we cure,
darn,
cure things? Hmm.
So these, we can, if we want to do, these can have outbreaks of dissidents, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like we have, and we have their tokens. Chips? Where are these tokens at?
They're there.
Okay. We're pandemicing this.
Okay.
Because someone in chat
explain for the viewers what that means?
So what we're going to do is now, when you free one of these heroes,
mm-hmm,
right now I've freed
Cyril?
This person.
Cyril.
Cyril.
Mm-hmm.
So this whole region now is going to become a region of serial sympathizers.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And we're going to place, they're going to outbreak around this area.
So that's helping me then.
So that's helping the rebellion.
Right, okay.
Because now you have an army of serials to spread out, and they can maybe help you search other stuff up.
Okay.
Okay.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea.
Cool.
Thank you, chat, for that. That's another way also of sort of compounding
it. Wait, who is chat?
Mm-hmm. Chat. I don't remember who. I don't know
it's
who it was.
Chat. Oh, it's Rough Dreamer.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Rough Dreamer. So with this, that also gives us another way to help out the Rebel player, because we've decided that odds are going to be stacked against the Rebel player.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
You know, in fact, that actually does mimic the Fantasy Flight games. Rebellion has a big thing where, as a Rebel player, you want to feel like odds are against you, so this game is going to capture that as well.
Okay.
I guess it's kind of Game of Thrones-ian as well. It's just going to feel
a lot
of despair.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of despair in Archer. I've never seen it, but it seems like it's a very
sad show. There's a lot of despair and humor.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Melancholy.
There's a lot of shit getting fucked up.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of,
there you go.
A lot of guns and stuff.
All right, so we have the basic core of the game.
Do we?
Isaiah, fix this.
Okay.
I got you halfway there. Let's finish it.
Yeah, number one thing I'm worried about is like, if they're both starting in the same space, do they affect each other?
Sure.
And then we essentially made it a 3-1 game, like you said, right? Mm-hmm. So that's also now stacked against the Rebel players.
So it's possible that Zombie Galactus isn't on a space. He occupies a region and terrorizes it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And when while he's terrorizing a region, you cannot place supporters in that region.
Okay. And these blue guys are going to be my supporters.
And the blue guys are going to be your supporters, in addition to
Those guys,
the dissidents. Right.
Okay.
Or the, I don't know, the whatever we're calling them, spies.
Yeah, spies.
And then, but the rebel or the imperial player who controls Zombie Galactus's army can move Zombie Galactus across this board as well.
Yeah.
And then eventually, if he moves to a region where there is an unmarked icon, that icon is removed, and that potentially makes you lose one permanently. So we have seven. If you can free four of these,
okay,
you win.
Okay.
If we can destroy four, we win. The only way we can destroy it is with Zombie Galactus.
Right. Okay.
Well then, okay, so these guys are going around revealing where they are, and then this happens. Then they start getting supporters.
He wants to he wants to reveal them.
Oh, you want to.
He wants to reveal them.
Okay.
These are can be used in two ways. We can either go toe to toe and try to fight him and chase him through the territories and actually do combat, or we can go around and take out some
picking out his supporters. Okay. Which are going to give me what, plus one modifiers or something?
Plus one modifiers
to my rolls, right?
To what
rolls?
Yes.
If we're in the territory, I get a plus one.
Can I write that on the big board?
Yeah, okay.
Plus one modifiers exist in this game now.
Okay.
Okay, can we do a quick overview of the rules we've established so far? Joe's gonna say something.
Read my mind, Dan.
Because we've run through several iterations, several kind of brainstorm sessions. What do we have that we've kept and that we're gonna use?
Well, here. I'll start because I'm also very confused.
Okay.
So we have still a kind of a three versus one kind of thing going on, where these two have the goal of destroying all the spies before he eats them or he reveals them and makes them safe or whatever. We have the spies that are hidden around this map. Some of them are going to be blanks, and we haven't really decided what happens when they're not there. But every time they're revealed, then three more copies or three more supporters will pop up in the neighboring towns. So that makes our job more difficult because we still have to destroy all those. And it makes yours a little bit easy because all you have to do is pick one of them. That's kind of what I got.
Okay. That's a little bit different than where I was coming from.
Oh, okay.
But I like that though.
Okay. Cool.
And then with these cards right here, so these represent the seven supporters, right? So if Isaias can find, locate one of the supporters. He has found Cyril. I guess he just needs to pick up one of these Cyril tokens. He has to be the one to reveal it. But if he can pick one up, then he gets to take the Cyril boosts.
Okay.
The ego boosts.
Two kinds of cards.
Yep, there's ego boosts and double ego boosts. Those help him move faster because they're boosting his energy. So he would get those to add to his deck. We would get some number of insults to add to our deck. So when he uses an ego boost, if he uses a Cyril ego boost, then we have a Cyril insult.
Okay.
We can say the insult, such as, "Boy, you are just so determined not to be cool about this." And then we can negate his boost.
Okay.
All right, so he needs to free them to get further, and they are giving him power-ups, but they're also giving us a way to combat those power-ups. So it's a little bit of a tug of war there. And then the core of the game is just, moving through, revealing tokens, and trying to find these seven people.
Yeah.
Okay, and I do remember,
And you said the kind of objective of the game is for either side, the TIE Fighter / Galactus side, or the X-Wing side, to save or destroy four characters.
Yep, trying to get the majority.
Okay.
So he's trying to free the majority, which it would be four in this case, and we're trying to make sure
that
he doesn't.
It's way too easy for these guys to win. So we're saying though that they can only kill Cyril if all of the Cyril tokens are gone. Not if you just take.
No, it's all of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
It's all of them.
So I think, and that's the question that I have for Nicole, right? So I feel like revealing these is the responsibility of the X-Wing player. I feel like we can't reveal these. So while we can guess where they are, because we're going to be sending Galactus there to devour these tokens, and that's our only way of getting rid of them before they're revealed. Once they are revealed, we can go and take out their tokens.
Okay, so what if because we have these things where we're using insults and he's using ego boost to move places. What if it's harder for him to reveal these certain cards if we put like insults on it? Because what I was kind of looking through here is we have the archer deck that we haven't used.
Right.
So we can have a starting hand that way. So you could always start with these ego boosts there.
Okay.
We can start with some basic insults and maybe by playing them on certain areas it makes it like harder for him to actually have to reveal that. I don't know, we're just making it harder for you, but also, I don't know.
Chad is suggesting we use Galakas as a neutral force, which is an interesting idea since it seems pretty hard for the one character to fight the three things that are kind of fighting with. I mean, that's just an idea to throw around, but I think that's a good idea.
That could be, yeah.
It could just be like nothing happens when he's in that region, right? So he could be like, I can't reveal if he's in that region, and you can't destroy if he's in that region.
So if we use Galakas as a neutral force, we have to give him an AI.
Uh-huh.
And we need to figure out how that would be programmed. So it's absolutely possible. Yeah. I don't know. Again, we can look at...
I think we need to break down actions. Because we have no... We have like an overview, but we have no specific things.
Thank you, Ninjanomics, for subscribing.
Yeah.
Another reminder. I'll just throw it out again. We do have this fancy schmancy Wheel of Misfortune. It might be a camera on right now. Over yonder. Whereupon, if you donate $25 or more, we gotta spin that damn thing. Crazy stuff will happen. The Zombie Galactus came from that. We have add a Snuggle Lord, add a D20, kill a rule, add a rule, someone has to wear a shark suit, stuff like that. I kind of am scared to see if someone donates it and see what comes up on that. But that's an option, so feel free to go crazy with that.
Yeah, we like more things thrown into the mix that will make it more difficult
than it
is right now.
So, Final Fantasy IX Master, I'm assuming that's what Fafix is,
Fafix.
Says that perhaps Galakas can just be controlled by both teams.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So we can choose to activate Galakas.
An ego mercenary.
Could be.
Like
you have to spend some resource. So it's interesting because in this hypothetical, if all the rebel has to do is reveal the seven areas that have these people in it, or four of the seven areas that have these people in it. And then once it's revealed, our job as the TIE fighters is to, we have to go out there and actually take all three of those out.
Okay.
It's possible that the rebel could just race us.
Yeah.
And then we're not gonna have a lot of direct conflict. Maybe we can sort of intercept him, but really it is kind of this pandemic vibe now, in that we are trying to put out these rebellions, and he is instigating the rebellions.
Okay, right.
So I would actually be curious, depending on how the mechanics go, I actually don't think it would be weighted that heavily for the Imperials, depending on how like the combat and stuff works.
Depending on how chaotic that he tries to start making.
It might be very difficult for them
If they're popping out, if only two came out, then they could negate what he's doing in the same turn, right?
Right.
With three, it's a little harder.
Right. Especially but he's also, remember, getting those ego boosts.
Right.
So he can move quicker,
in
theory.
Mm-hmm.
Someone's also saying, is there a mechanic to stop Galakas for a round? Maybe you want to do that. We haven't played through an iteration of this, so we don't know, you know, how scary Galakas is just yet.
Yeah, but we can make him as scary as he needs to be. Haven't really determined how we're moving.
Yeah, let's do the actions here.
Okay.
We have two different, it's asymmetrical, right?
Okay.
So they have to have different lists of actions that they can do.
Okay.
The rebel, they can both move. The rebel's just revealing, which is going to do that spawn thing. The empire is just going to kill. So each one of these is one action.
Mm-hmm.
The empire can also attack. I don't think that the rebel would want to attack, right? It's kind of like a secret thing that he's doing, is instigating this rebellion. And then this is the Galacticus zombie. That I don't know if that can be an action as well. Is like, as one of my actions, I can move Galakas, and then that is the neutral zone, which is like there, nothing can happen
at that zone.
Okay.
And so then, if we fall into maybe some unbalance, then the rebels would get like a certain amount of actions, and the Empire would get a certain amount of actions. Right?
Yep.
Hmm.
And so.
So one thing to think about, so if we are doing Zombie Galakas.
Oh no.
Oh, someone really wants
Someone donated here.
spinning.
Is it sharky time? Hashtag waxing.
Thank you, Alakis, for that donation. Nicole, you want to do the honors? All right, here we go. Right. Give that a healthy spin.
I'm hoping shark.
Oh, man. It's going to be out of second Galactus.
Oh!
Okay.
Yes! Shark.
Wow, we hit sharky.
Many things happen.
Okay, so someone has to wear the shark costume for
10 minutes.
Do we have a volunteer, or should we?
We had a volunteer.
Yeah, I'll do it. Yeah,
that's fine.
He has been waiting.
I'm already super hot.
Suit up.
I am that.
There you go.
This is just gonna add to my hotness.
Wow.
I have to put
Where do you guys even get this
guy? Yeah, it's a full on left shirt. You know, I don't think you realize that when you signed up for that, Isaiah. Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. So what I was gonna say while Isaiah is
slowly sharking up.
If Galactus is controlled by both, can be controlled by both teams, we do have a potential issue. If there's no other way to mitigate the action economy, you could get into a point where we move Galactus back. And then you move Galactus back, and you have this sort of like stalemate. Right. Now, a lot of times, like games, when you're developing them, you can see these, and you know the response is like, well, players just wouldn't do that.
Right.
But a lot of times, players will do what they can.
Oh, okay. No, I know. You have a
players can do what
room.
They can to break the game.
Somebody want to zip me up?
Joe with the sounds. What a dork. I apologize for that shouting.
There you go. Wait. You hear your music?
Sometimes I'm loud.
Can you put the fin?
You
like,
look great though.
Yeah.
You got a fin.
Is there a fin back there?
Yeah, there's a fin back there. What?
There we go.
Oh, there we go.
This just looks wrong.
No, it looks great. What? Oh.
No. What is happening?
All right.
Oh, that's shark romance.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Shark.
Oh my god.
All right, there you go. Do we have a timer for this, or are we just gonna? No one's
starting
a timer.
I'm not even setting a timer. I'm just gonna let him run. Okay, I'll set a timer. I got
so
a timer.
We need to figure out a way. If we are gonna do the both players can control Galactus, we need to figure out a way to do that. I am almost advocating for the Imperial players control Galactus, and it's sort of their way of moving forward.
Okay.
And making sure that they can get things moving. Mm-hmm. That's what I would say.
He could be like the sign of the end of times, right? So I still think we should add the thing as fire, and as he moves along the map, like certain things become inaccessible.
Okay.
So moving him will be consequential to both sides, because if we start burning half the map, then none of us can get to the things that we need.
Right. So what you're saying then is
but burning those things also help these guys, right?
I'll listen to whatever you say with the shark fin.
So. Right? Is that what you were gonna say?
Yeah. I'm saying like that would help. But so let's give the rebel player a choice then. Maybe they actually get to look at the token.
Okay.
And they can choose whether to reveal it as
me. Okay.
Yeah. As the rebels or whatever.
Somebody had kind of a cool suggestion right before the sharkiness happened. Somebody put, what if there's two teams both trying to take on Galactus, and it kind of is like a competitive co-op kind of game? You both want to go Galactus, but
the team that takes them down. So that's like a side objective?
Like the rebels against the Empire trying to take on Galactus.
That's an idea.
With seven, we could do it so that Galactus is capturing souls.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And if Galactus gets too many souls, then Galactus will...
Galactus wins.
Win.
Right, we don't want that. Okay.
And then if we're both controlling Galactus, then we have to figure out a reason to do that. Why would I ever want to risk Galactus eating a soul if that's going to hinder my...
Right.
So he must do something, like, amazing. Or do you already think are we still going with the thing that he is... causing nothing to happen in a certain area? Or is
he's just shutting off parts of the board?
I'm open to anything, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think that's neat. I don't know what that would do.
I think we should go back to what an actual turn would look like. So if we're starting to do a thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And from there we can figure out the rest of it.
Yeah, because we still haven't even really determined how we're moving. Mm-hmm. Is this really just gonna be us going along the things? Because it could be really easy, because then you could just flood and open up all these things.
A lot of these questions that we have may be determined by just running through a turn and seeing how it works, and then we'd have more ideas, more information.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure that if we're rolling dice that we get Isaiah to roll it.
Okay.
Because I want to see some shark rolls.
Okay. So let's start with.
That was well rolled for a shark hand.
Okay. All right. So let's take Galactus off. Galactus doesn't come on at the beginning of the game.
Okay.
It comes on somewhere, some trigger.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We're gonna start you there.
I'm gonna start up here. A lovely Skagos.
We might need to start closer to, if we're really trying to intercept, but we can position ourselves.
We can all start there, right?
We all start here?
Yeah.
But then,
sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
We can try it.
Sure.
What's the worst thing that's going to happen? It's going to work?
Yeah.
All right.
And I would go first because I can't attack, right?
Okay.
That's part of the action. I can move, reveal, and we're not doing this anymore.
No.
Someone in chat mentioned that it was hilarious that you were like trying to be serious in the shark costume. I would agree with them.
Mm-hmm. I'm a very serious person.
Yeah, he is actually.
What's the, how does it feel in there? Is it pretty toasty?
It's so hot.
Super hot.
I already wore a sweater today, so this is even worse. Do you guys know what swamp ass is?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I can show you.
Oh, no.
I don't know. I'm sure it's a quite common shark problem.
Yeah, it's a common shark problem.
Shark ass. Shark
so ass. I can move reveal. These guys can move kill.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And attack.
Okay. So, how many actions do you get? We have the archer cards.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So two.
Here's your ego boosters. I don't know if you want to hold those or.
So, yeah, I would think that the rebellions or.
Those are ego boosts for Cyril.
We would have two actions.
We have archer insults.
We can do two actions insults. Of these.
Okay.
These I can just show at any time when I move to boost my move.
Okay.
So, what if, how many cards do you have?
Not that many.
You have, I have eight.
I can't, four?
So you have four? Okay,
so. Four cards, so I have four cards.
So you have four of the insults, I have four of the insults.
Okay.
So let's do it this way. Okay. Let's say that each card that you put down is an action.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, but you can boost with an ego boost. So you can add it. You can add an ego boost to a card or to your move action to move farther.
Okay.
Okay. You'd have to move exponentially farther because otherwise you just unless you can only do one move action per turn.
Right.
So.
So how much time do you have?
We can say that. So.
Yeah.
It's just. Oh, half our time is gone.
Already?
Half our time is gone.
That's fine.
I think we're in a good place though.
In 3 minutes we'll be done. We'll be playing it for the last 15 minutes. All right. Okay. So you play a card to move.
Mm-hmm.
You can play an ego boost, as many ego boosts as you want to move farther.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay? But that's all your actions.
Mm-hmm.
The other actions, you can spend cards to reveal locations.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay.
And then let's say that if you reveal a location with one of these spies there, mm-hmm. you can then spend your ego boosts to add more of their chits onto the board.
Okay.
So that maybe you always get one, but then you can add more.
Right.
So okay.
There's a lot of uses for these.
Let me have those cards. That
these
way
ones?
I can have more cards to do the action.
Okay.
I still think.
Wasn't it you that wanted coffee?
Yeah.
Oh, here you go.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks.
You all have cups now?
We've had cups for a long time.
Y'all are not messing around.
Oh, caffeine.
That's really hot, dude.
He's a shark, bro.
Yeah, it is really hot.
It's really hot. All right, don't.
Oh, this is. Oh, take a picture of this, please, forever. I want this to be my new background. So bad. So bad.
Anybody else want coffee?
I'm good.
Okay.
I'm
good. Thank you.
So your deck. So here's your starting deck.
Yep.
Okay.
I got dead cards and I got boost and double boost. Okay.
But you have to draw four.
Right. We're trying to make it like a deck builder.
It's
where we're like unlimited.
Right.
Yeah.
So now our insults though. So we can use these. We can move as many times as we want. Or no, we're using using our parts to attack as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think
we should, as a way to try and see if it's harder for us, we should also keep ourselves with the same restrictions, and then we can change it.
We just don't have the boosts.
Right.
Which is fine, because he's gonna go faster than us.
Yeah.
Right.
Because there's two of you.
So we can use our insults as movement cards,
mm-hmm.
or we can use our insults to negate ego boosts.
Sounds good.
To negate a double ego boost, you gotta use two insults.
Two.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they have to be associated with the character of the ego boost. That way, while we're getting more of these characters involved, we're having like counters and other powers.
Okay.
So the more of these are gonna get, it's gonna be harder for us to
have the right
counters to counter.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
okay.
So it's this risk and reward.
You just have to keep in mind that the backs are labeled. Like, they tell you what character you're going to have.
Good.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Good.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know why that's
don't,
good.
Don't look at them, then. Don't look at them at all. All right. On the back.
Okay. We could say,
So let's try it. Let's run through a move.
No,
okay. It's my turn first, right? Yep, I'm gonna get four cards. Someone shuffle this already?
Yeah, you can shuffle it.
Yeah.
Can I?
Yeah, you can.
I mean,
Sharky Shuffle.
Sharky Shuffle. That's fine. Didn't need that. That card's extra, extraneous. Right.
You think it was a lucky card or unlucky card?
You can put it in.
Okay.
So
it's two. It's unlucky.
Three, four.
So okay. just one action per turn, right?
So you can have as many actions as you want your cards, right?
Oh,
like you
okay.
Get your whole hand.
I guess if it's a deck, though, where are you?
Yeah.
Until you run out of cards.
Max hand size 4.
Okay.
Right now.
Because, yeah.
Alright, so I'm gonna move.
Mm-hmm.
And I play a card to reveal as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a card is revealed. Okay. So you're moving. So you, right now you can move one.
I'm gonna double boost.
Okay, do we want to spend two cards to stop him from double boosting?
No, because
you can't draw
okay.
until the end of your turn. Right? So
yeah,
maybe,
I feel like, yeah, I don't really
one
like
move,
I don't really
and
like
then
reaction.
Double boost.
Okay.
Wait, I should just like go in here. Wait. Those nodes are connected, right? So I can go one,
yeah, that's fine.
Two, three.
You're also in a flying vehicle.
Yeah.
So.
It's true.
Yeah.
All okay. right. So that.
And
so it's your move.
I'm gonna reveal.
Kay.
Okay. Okay.
Nothing.
Damn it. Okay. Now fuck this game. All right.
All right. You've already lost. You okay, already lost.
No. I'm still good. Right.
Okay. Yep.
And I could do one more thing with this. So I'll just move.
The rough part is now his next turn he has no cards.
So next turn he's gonna draw. So
yeah,
he's gonna
draw.
Oh, like a deck right.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
You draw
gotcha.
At the end of your turn, so I'm gonna draw four new cards. So these are now discarded.
Okay.
And so now I draw four new cards, and now it's your guys.
What a wild mechanic.
So we want to try to attack him.
Okay.
Attacking him will get rid of, make him discard cards or something, or is there actually, can we actually kill him?
Well, we need a damage counter.
Yeah, I don't like. All right. Elimination's always kind of weird. So
yeah, especially when it's
2v1.
Yeah.
What would be the? We have eights. One eight. Here, there you go. You have eight health now.
All right. If he goes down to zero, he starts back at the beginning.
Okay.
Oh, that's the timer.
Oh.
So
for the shark suit?
I guess the shark suit can come off, but it seems like such a good addition to the show.
I think
show.
All of our best ideas have come from the shark suit.
Yeah.
Unzip.
Maybe the shark suit right. just moves around.
All right, bye, Sharky. Bye-bye. It's been fun.
It has been fun.
Thank you. There you go. You're out.
Wow. It's steam heat.
I know.
All right.
Don't look at me.
We're going to take our turns, Isaiah, while you're back there.
Yeah.
So okay. I'll be this person right here. I'm going to move one, two, three, and then four. I'm gonna get right up on him.
Okay.
Okay. And so, can I not reveal, but I can look? Or is that only his?
No, you can't look.
Can't look. Oh, I feel like there should be another objective for me because I can, right. I'm gonna do the same thing, because mm-hmm. I can move.
It sounds like there should be another objective for you.
Mm-hmm.
So what would that objective
be? How did I get your cards? I'm sorry.
We could do
those
are discarded.
Okay.
We could do the burn, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where you guys wanted to wake. Scorch the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Could just start with that. Yeah, and after maybe a certain amount of scorched earth, this guy comes out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if there's scorched earth, then when I spawn, then no one can spawn in that spot.
Hmm. Then that would just, okay. Well, I'm gonna try to move, so let's see. So let's go, I wanna move one. And I wanna move with the actual insult, so. On this card, this insult is, that is a foot in your face. Smell the embarrassment, because Archer Cold's the best.
Yeah.
So, and then.
We're gonna smell the embarrassment because he just spent 10 minutes marinating in a shark costume.
Yeah, exactly,
yeah.
Exactly. Oh. And, so there's nothing else I can really do on my turn other than go and attack him.
Mm-hmm.
Or do something with building towards Galactus. Okay, I got it. I can discard a card, it is no longer part of my deck to redraw.
Okay.
To bring out Galactus. So this one will be a tribute
that's
to Galactus.
So
how many of those are we gonna have to get before we bring out Galactus?
Right. A lot. Or
seven.
Sure.
He's a click. He's a hero click, so mm-hmm. we can actually go. Oh my god, he has so many clicks.
Mm-hmm.
Too many clicks. We'll say seven. Seven's good.
Seven.
One,
okay.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, so mm-hmm. click it this way.
Okay,
click it. Once it gets a KO, he's coming out.
Okay.
Boom.
Cool. All right, so that was my two actions. Turn's done.
Turns down. Okay.
Discard the rest of my cards in my hand, which I will then just draw up again.
You're drawing up. Yeah. Because we're not actually adding anything to our decks yet.
Okay. Cool.
And I can't do anything to stop us, right? The rebellion's just kind of.
She's a ticking time bomb kind of thing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So your next turn.
Alright, so I'm gonna move. And nobody attacked me.
I couldn't get that far because you had double boosted. So next turn I'll be able to attack you.
Gotcha.
Wait. Reveal. You didn't see that card.
Damn, what is going on here?
I forgot to use the ones I wrote on. This is playtesting, so let's just say
I did.
You got one.
Right? Okay.
Just to see what happens. Let's see what happens. Four.
Sure.
So number four is Krieger.
No, right? It's yeah, it is Krieger. Yeah.
Okay. Alright. Actually we always have.
Do you get the blank cards too? Or do you just get the boosts?
I get the blank ones. Oh no. Yeah.
I thought we got the blank ones.
No, you guys got the blank ones.
Yeah.
I put the blank ones in with the boosts.
The blank ones are your dead cards.
My dead cards.
Okay.
So we get the insults, 1, 2, 3, so four.
These
five.
Go into my discards, right?
Yes. Okay. You get 4 Krieger insults. I get 4 Krieger insults in my discard.
And then.
Okay, and then we have 3 Krieger things here, or do they?
Okay.
They burst.
They burst. All right. They pandemic style into other places.
Yeah, I think it should be. Should be one on each adjacent.
Okay. 3 mm-hmm. adjacent continents or whatever. Okay.
Well, we're doing every adjacent right now.
Gotcha.
Full on pandemic outbreak.
All right.
That one's not adjacent. Come on, dude. You're cheating again.
I can't see from here.
Haven't even finished designing it and you're already cheating.
If the shark shoots off, you should be able to.
All right.
I think we're just doing it by color, too. I don't think it's by the actual lines.
It's by the lines.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
So this now. Does this come off or does this also count as a creature?
So you've. No. What do you think?
It should also be Krieger.
We should replace
what
the
do
Krieger.
Little Krieger things do, though?
So those are like the little dissidents. So
okay.
We need to figure out. So what do they do? Are they just a thing for us to get rid of?
Mm-hmm.
What?
We're gonna lose so bad.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Okay, maybe there's, when there's you reveal these spies, they throw something else into the game. That makes there's things two. More difficult. I don't know. Let's see.
Or maybe. The TIE Fighter dudes have to kill a certain number of those as a secondary victory condition.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. The problem though is that we like then.
Then are they chasing the TIE? Are they chasing the X-wing down? Are they just shooting the stuff he makes?
Let's play another couple turns just because we can see how this is gonna go. So right now it doesn't seem the problem that I'm having is that the Rebel player really doesn't have a lot of choice involved. Mm-hmm. They're literally just gonna race around and uncover things as fast as possible.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Well, what if, as I can also do a move action to move my Kriegers, right? And try to get them to the base.
Oh.
So we're like defending this. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Hmm.
So if I do that, but then I get to move all of them.
All Kriegers one space?
What?
Okay.
Okay. But I'm gonna ego boost them so they move 2. Why is that guy there? Okay. So 1, 2. And this guy is just gonna make it hard for you because he's that kind of guy.
Oh, okay. Wow. So this is like if the individual like things just had a mind of their own to start scattering. Okay.
Okay.
Hmm.
Okay, so this is definitely kind of cool. So you can definitely turn into chaos really fast.
So that I guess so you don't actually need to get here then. If you can actually use cards to move your other your pawns, that makes it even more difficult for us.
Okay.
So, but there's 2 of us though, so we can see what happens.
Right.
All right.
And
so,
then you have Galactus coming, right?
Galactus comes in.
Right.
We have to pay for him though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This should be in addition to ones we kill, go there too.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay.
I don't remember what that one was. All right. Our turn. Simultaneous.
There's a lot of rules in this game.
Yeah, this is, okay. Simultaneous.
It's fantasy flight, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is legit. All right, so I'll take my turn. I'm gonna move, attack. Oh my god, you're so cocky right now. Attack, do I need to roll anything to attack? I just kill it.
I probably should just kill it.
Okay, just kill it.
Because it would suck to go all the way over there and then roll and miss.
Right, yeah, that's true.
All right, so I'm gonna move.
You guys can also attack me, right? So if we're not rolling dice and you're just attacking me, then it might help.
But I'm gonna attack.
Maybe we just can't attack you. I don't know if we need that to have that in there because I don't know what it does when we get you to 0.
Mm-hmm.
Let me forget the beginning, especially because you don't have to. Well, you don't have to move. You can just move done stuff from us all day. Mm-hmm. Alright, okay. So I've shuffled my deck.
Yes.
I've shuffled my Kriegers.
Oh yeah, because we killed a Krieger.
Okay.
Okay.
So now we can counter his Krieger boosts with Krieger
with
insults.
Krieger, I don't have any Krieger cards in my hand right now.
But not in your hand right now, but when you reshuffle you will.
Okay.
Alright. It is your turn.
I'm gonna move the Kriegers first.
Are you still trying to get here for a reason that we have not disclosed yet?
Yeah, we were trying to get it to like, he gets four of them in the
if
base.
If I get 7 tokens here, then I win.
7 total?
Yes.
Okay.
7's okay. Number that we're going with?
Right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. You win.
Right.
Or do you get to control Galactus? Because we're trying to tribute, and you're trying to invade. Maybe that's how you can control Galactus.
Okay.
And then once we get, if we get to 10, we can take control of Galactus.
Okay, that'd be good. Then you basically have like another phase of the game that's like super boss hard. Right?
Yeah. More rules for you.
Yeah.
More rules.
Galactic phase.
All right. All right.
So then I'm gonna move and boost my guy. Wait, I don't have to boost. I can just move.
You're gonna search.
And reveal.
Okay. 3.
Cyril.
Cyril.
Okay.
Is that, you guys know all the characters.
I know.
There's your ego boosts.
Oh, here's blank cards. Does he get blank cards?
Do you get the blank cards? Or we put? I don't remember.
I think I did.
Yeah, give him the blank cards.
All right, here. Take
that
all.
That just makes us.
That gives him a lot of actions, though, right?
But he's still only drawing 4
I can only
cards.
Draw 4. Oh, right. Okay.
It just makes it harder for him to boost.
Gotcha.
But that might not be a bad thing, because like I said, now it's almost we've flopped it.
Mm-hmm.
I really feel like the rebels at a huge advantage right now.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. Mm-hmm. So we'll have to see. I mean, now it's like we're like the poor Imperials who are trying our best to summon Zombie Galactus to save us from these
your best hope rebels. Some giant stupid weapon.
Yeah.
He is our last hope.
A Death Star. Maybe.
And then I'll do my last move and move these guys here. So 1, 2.
So I remember I played a game where when certain things came out, it was basically like Risk, and it was like a territory control, but it also had nuclear bombs.
Mm-hmm.
And so what you would do is you
Risk
just
Legacy?
No, I can't remember what it was called. It's gonna kill me now because I played it and reviewed it. But it's they would have a thing where you'd basically nuke a thing where you would put it down here, and after a certain amount of turns, this spot is gonna explode. Or burn.
That's just adding more rules.
But yeah, let's keep it.
I know. Well, you guys add more rules. I want to add more rules.
No, I like that. But I mean, but so maybe like once you get to a certain like point, you know, like maybe we know where Galactus is gonna come out.
Okay.
Right? Because that is kind of like Blood Rage, where you know where Ragnarok is going to happen.
So right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ooh! There you go. Galactus is going to come out.
So Galactus, this is 2?
2. Mm-hmm.
So we'll mark this as like
Galactus Zone.
Galactus Zone.
Okay.
So when Galactus comes out, he was going to come out there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let that influence your decision. Mm-hmm. You're done with your turn?
Okay. Yeah, I'm done.
Alright, it's our turn now. So are you going to deal with some of these dudes?
Yeah, I'll fly back and just.
All right, so I'm using a card to move, taking out this guy, and that third card, and moving again.
And I gotta shuffle under the table. So
it's yep.
Okay. All right.
So this is
kind
of an interesting, like, pandemic variant, in that like It's funny because the entire game basically is what one person in chat said. They're like, pandemic! And we're like, sure!
And then
sure, why not?
We're gonna explode one.
Mm-hmm.
What's the ruling on this? Do I need to move again?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Then, you need to be in a spot.
Oh, he's gonna get that anyways.
Remember, he has to use a whole card to do that, though.
And you guys cannot destroy those, right?
Correct.
No.
So I can move here, but then nothing happens.
Yeah, but if he doesn't use a card to move it,
mm-hmm.
you can kill it next turn.
Right.
So. Gotcha.
Okay.
So yeah, it's weird because it's like this pandemic variant where the disease is controlled, has like a mind of its own.
Yeah.
Which
it starts spreading and you're like, I gotta go pick these guys off, right? And run around all these different spaces.
Right.
So somehow the Empire has turned into the good guys and the Rebellion.
I don't know what to say turned into.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they kind of were the whole
thing. We're
all
kind of like, morally gray in this game, right?
Okay.
So the other element we have is we have this. So let's break this down and see what we have and what we like and what we don't like.
Okay.
So we have this sort of pandemic-esque putting out fires. That's really what we're doing, right? The TIE fighters are going around. There's more of us, and we're trying to go put out fires. You're trying to start fires. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's kind of built in. There's this interesting tug of war, because once these characters are revealed, you're trying to get them back to the Iron Island, and we're trying to get rid of them to feed Galactus.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And before they go away.
Yeah. So far it looks like it's pretty easy to feed Galactus compared to getting them all the way over here, so.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because they have once they spawn, they start,
because they move slowly, just the one,
And you burn one card to move one of them,
all of them.
Oh, okay.
But see, once he comes out then, he's basically giving you another character, right?
Right.
So he's then going to be able to kill the guys too.
Right. Mm-hmm. We do have one issue though, is that our win condition right now doesn't work, in that we don't have a way to track it. Originally, our win condition was to kill four of these insurgents. Right. So, I mean, we have to do that basically to. I mean, I guess it still works.
If we basically just have to get rid of a character. So, if you and I actually just worked together in like a cooperative game sense and went after certain specific characters, like if we just like, oh, we're almost done with Krieger. We're almost done with Krieger. We should just focus on Krieger and things like that.
Okay. So next turn, he hypothetically is going to say, I'm going to move. Maybe the Galactus thing isn't the tug of war thing that we're talking about. Maybe it's he gets here, now he has freed one Krieger, he has 1 point.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's like, okay, we got to make sure that he doesn't also free him. Once he gets to four characters of any of the characters.
Yeah, that actually kind of goes back to what we originally said, too.
Right.
Yeah, where he just needed four of those.
Okay. Yeah, any one of those to that area. If you get four unique characters to that area,
all right,
you get it. If we can fill this up with 10 or more, we get to bring out Galactus to help us out.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Which basically, we'll start burning certain areas or killing certain things.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think that clarifies the win condition for me. Okay. We still don't know what Galactus does.
Nope, and we won't find out for another...
Five turns.
Yeah. And then I do want to stop and talk about the deck building element of this.
Sure.
And how that feels.
This happened, which is...
So that's a problem.
Right, yeah.
Right? So we need to figure out how to deal with this, because it feels weird for us. We're getting... I don't know of any deck builders, if you guys do know one, where you're adding in full chunks of cards during the game.
Right.
Normally you're adding one card to your deck at a time.
Right.
So, perhaps when he gets the outbreak and we start killing these characters, maybe we're only adding in like one insult for everyone we kill or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that way it's not like we don't get this chunk. I mean, it kind of depends either way.
It also seems like, the card, the face of the card doesn't really matter. You're just kind of burning them, and the only thing that matters is the card itself.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right?
Right.
We haven't really come up where we've wanted to deny him boosts yet based on a certain character, have we?
And I don't think we should do that. I mean, that seems... I never like it in a game when you're like, okay, I'm going to play this card,
and then
the other guy's like, no, you're not. Mm-hmm. Like, that's very munchkin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right.
Which
I'm
is
with that.
Not fun.
No, I'm with that. I'm with you there. So then it depends... So then... Is there a reason for us to want these characters' cards in our decks? If we're not, countering.
Right.
Do we, maybe...
Chat, any suggestions?
So this makes it harder for us.
Mm-hmm.
But perhaps we need that character's card to take out that character.
I was thinking about that earlier.
It seems like it could be really difficult for us.
Because we're only going to...
Because you're only drawing four.
And we're only drawing one every time we... Kill one.
Mm-hmm. No. In this case, we would both
stack.
Get four.
Oh, we get all. Okay.
But as the deck gets built bigger, it's going to be harder for us to kill. This is where the balance comes in, right? Because if it turns out that we actually are, having a easy time at taking them out, then the fact that as the game goes on, it's harder for us to kill these insurgents.
Yeah.
Right, because we've burned some of the. There's only so few of those cards that we haven't used to burn them off,
right.
So we have to go fishing for them.
Right.
Okay.
And it also leads to an element that's not really fun if we're sitting
there
like
we're just
not
waiting for cards and
stuff. Yeah.
Well, let's play it a bit more and then we could, I don't know, figure out a way that we could rush through the deck. No, we're going to reset? Mm-hmm. All right, let's reset.
We only have so much time, right? We got to...
If we had more time and we could build a more complicated game, then maybe that card element comes into play.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I generally for the show, simpler is better, because we only have about 20 or minutes or so to actually play the game once we build it.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, it goes so fast.
But there's definitely ways, I see you could have this be a board game plus a deck building game with all kinds of intricacies therein, right?
That's definitely been the games that I've liked more recently. Uh-huh. Deck building, just as kind of like a game genre, has kind of evolved to, it's not enough just to have a deck builder, you have to have a deck builder along with other elements. Yeah. Some of my favorite games that are coming out now are ones that have that.
If I had to describe what this genre of game would be, it would be if you combined Game of Thrones Risk with X-Wing minis and Archer carts.
Right.
And that's like the genre.
That's the genre.
Plus Zombie Galactus.
Plus Zombie Galactus. Play that, yeah.
So one really quick thing that we could say with the cards is maybe we are getting more insult cards. Mm-hmm. And maybe we can use the insult cards if we get like pairs to just do
double things.
Yeah. I guess it would be triple, but either way.
Okay.
We can leave that out for now.
There's an archer insult.
So for your deck, you were saying that your deck got too big too quick.
Yeah. Not that it was a problem yet, but I could see how it's totally useless for me to have a huge deck because I'm only drawing four cards at a time. So for me to ever get a Krieger or whatever, it's going to be really hard.
Right. I'm with you.
Alright, get all this together.
There's a really good game like this. It's like a deck building spy game. It's called Web of Spies, if anybody's ever played that. So that one actually has crates that you actually have to go get, and there's pawns, and then you're using the deck building mechanic to move, so you're doing the same thing, like I'm going to move one.
Right.
And then you reveal to do the power that's written on there.
Okay.
So that one is, it was kickstarted about a year ago, 2 years ago. It's called Medeiros, was the designer.
Mm-hmm.
I have a copy.
So for this, you can place one, and we'll take turns placing them.
Why does it matter?
Because, I don't know, because we need a way to set them up.
Okay. Well, why wouldn't I just set them up?
You can do that. But when that outbreak happens, though, we're going to be right there.
All right.
Here you go.
You're
right there.
So I want more notes.
And
I
if more there notes. Was
at the thing, okay.
There could be some strategery involved in this part, too. Like, this could be
now we have
a thing.
Mm-hmm. Well, we didn't actually mix any blanks in there, did we? Either. Were there any?
Didn't you?
I don't know. I didn't.
There's some in there. No.
There should be three blanks.
Yeah, there's four blanks in the beginning.
Okay.
Mix it up again.
All right. And we still don't know what Galactus does, so if you want to decide that while we're setting up.
You decide.
Galactus, what does Galactus do? Scary.
So we're pretty much agreed upon that whenever Galactus pops out, he's gonna make it harder for the rebel player.
The X-Wing player.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And just what that looks like, we haven't determined yet. Maybe he immediately comes out and just kills an archer character.
Mm-hmm.
Just bam, he's out. And that four to win, so.
I was thinking if we're rolling and that's he comes out at one, then he kills everyone in that region.
So we flip these over, and if they are these characters, they're just gone.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we should up that then to like 20 or something.
Okay.
Because 10, like, we're going to get there really. I mean, we can do 10.
Yeah.
All right, it's fine.
It's fine.
10's fine. Yeah. Easier to count to 10. Twice as hard to count to 20. okay, so. Do we want to do a rundown of the rules really quick?
Let's do a reiteration of the rules.
All right,
got a lot of rules going on.
So here's what we're doing. This game, the object of this game is the X-Wing player is trying to fly around Westeros and save four of the seven spies.
Yeah.
We, the TIE fighters, are trying to stop that from happening by killing up these spy clones. Each turn, the players are going to have four cards that they get to take actions with. And in order to do an action, you have to discard one card. It can be of any kind. That will allow you, if you are the rebel players, to move or to reveal one of these chips here to see if it's a spy or not.
Mm-hmm.
The Empire can move, kill the rebel or the rebels that show up.
Mm-hmm.
They can no longer attack.
They can no longer attack. We're taking that out. The object of the game is for the X-Wing player can also use a card to move the rebels that pop up. Correct?
Oh yeah.
And we'll get Galactus in there in a second. So basically, and then what, how are we doing the deck building? Are we even going to have deck building? Let's not have deck building. We don't really need it, right? Because you're not getting powers.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I think the bulk of the game works without it.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay. All right. Simpler's better. No, simpler's better.
We don't have a way to work it in right now, so mm-hmm. let's just play it without and see what happens.
Okay.
You do have a pseudo deck builder because he has boosts mm-hmm. that he can choose to spend right. efficiently mm-hmm. and non-boost cards, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
So when you reveal a spy, flip it over, mm-hmm. adjacent territories get a little spy token.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so three more of them of that whatever character is revealed. So we have the numbers kind of correlating to which ones are kind of hidden on the board. So okay. last time we revealed it was Krieger, and we basically would pop it open so all mm-hmm. of these guys then come around here.
And the objective for the X-Wing player is to, these guys can move one space at a time. Yeah. You can mm-hmm. use a card to move all of them. Mm-hmm. And the objective is to get those players to this little home base. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Four yeah. wins?
Yeah, if he four gets wins. One of these, puts them back here, four he unique. Just needs four unique characters.
Okay.
Yep. And we're trying to prevent that from happening, and then trying to eradicate characters. So if we can wipe all of Krieger's tokens off the board before any of them are saved, then we got a point in our win column.
Okay.
If we can get four of these spy / diseases mm-hmm. eradicated, mm-hmm. then we win the game.
Okay.
Yeah, and then as the game goes on, we can also burn cards, and as we kill these agents, it basically feeds Galactus.
Gotcha.
And at you know once we get 10 on him there, then he can get in here and basically start burning individual like huge right. territories. So it's basically like, yeah, it'll just speed up the game.
Yes, mm-hmm. it adds basically a timer so that like the longer that he takes to go through, mm-hmm. we're going to unleash Galactus and it's going to be more difficult. Because gotcha. That's the only way that we have of killing spies before they're revealed.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So right now your insults in here don't do anything.
Nope.
Because they're all insults.
They're just actions.
Okay.
All right. There's just a way for me to track actions. Because we have not figured out how the characters would work.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Cool.
All right. You go first.
Yep. We don't have these on the board.
Right. I'm just going to move. I'm gonna reveal. That's a 5.
What's Snow TS with controls.
We need like 50 cats and 2 dozen dog bones at this point.
Last week we had our game did not kind of manifest in the way we thought it would, and we ended up with 50 cats and 2 dozen dog bones on the table and
like real dog bones?
Well, they were toy bones. The cats were toys too.
I was thinking the bones of dogs.
That would have been a more interesting scene.
Yeah.
That would have been a more interesting scene. That's for sure.
It's
a little messier, but.
Oh, this is also adjacent, right?
I'm gonna. It was here. So yeah, it is actually.
There we go.
Yeah.
So I'm going to. 5 Mallorys, we can even imagine.
I'm gonna sacrifice Mallory because she's a total bitch in the show.
Okay.
And I'm gonna move and double boost. And
Mama,
go,
Mama of the Year.
1, 2, 3.
So in that circumstance, mm-hmm. why did you not bank her?
Because this will just keep you busy, right?
Because
this gives me more of a lead ahead of you.
Gotcha.
Okay. I just don't want you tanking the game on purpose. So you're saying that you did that for strategic reasons?
That's strategy.
Strategy that I chose.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we get 4 actions mm-hmm. for our cards. We obviously have to deal with that. So I'll move, and I will get rid of that Mallory token. I will move and get rid of that Mallory token.
All right.
Bam Bam Sam says, if the table was to spontaneously combust this episode, it would still have gone better than last week. We didn't actually make a game last week.
Oh really?
We kind of, I don't know what we did for 2 hours, but it.
Dog bones, cats, like how bad can that be, honestly?
It was an episode. It was an episode.
Steve Riss is saying last week was awesome.
It was awesome in the sense that we had fun, but we didn't really make a game.
And explode.
Which is
fun. Oh wait, so he's doing the Key and Peele thing. In fact.
Oh yes, the twist.
All right, I did my thing, blew some pup.
Are we getting rid of this 5 now? This is gone, right?
Oh yeah, we already revealed it, so don't need it.
Hey okay. Joe, what's our timer looking like?
All right.
He's at not at the desk.
I think it looks like it's 7:30.
Oh, so okay. About half an hour.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. So we've taken our turn. Mm-hmm. Your turn.
And here's the thing, right? Because I can always... I just need to get one of these so I can move an ego boost. And then I can move.
Oh! Uh-oh. Saves Topian with the donation.
Situational game testing. Time to spin that wheel.
All right.
Hashtag yeah. Neonet.
Who wants to spin this thing?
I will spin.
Okay.
Yeah.
Spin it up.
They knew we were getting too comfortable.
I know. We yeah. had like
it
a
was
game.
Going too well.
Like, oh, shit,
going
we have
too
rules
well.
And
yeah.
actions.
This
and...
shouldn't happen.
That was too weak.
That was the worst.
Yes! Add a all d20. Right. Add a d20. Okay. Okay. This is what they wanted. This is what they wanted.
D20. Okay.
Do we have a d20? Where is the d?
Oh, we don't even. Oh.
Is it over here?
We may not.
There's a bunch of dice somewhere. I'm gonna get on that. I'm
all
getting
right,
on
the D20.
Yeah.
BRB.
There is no nerd office if you don't have a D20.
D20.
They're around here somewhere.
How are we gonna use a D20? Oh, curses.
We've designed the game without any dice.
No dice in the game at all. Now there is the king of all dice.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So do we have like 20? No, that's not gonna work.
No, we need a D20. There's a D20 in this office.
Oh no, I know there's a D20 somewhere. In this office. Mm-hmm. I like randomizations, like maybe
how many,
certain things blow up,
how many
do
cards
certain
are here?
Characters come out, like what happens?
There's 20. Okay, what if when you roll the die,
I got it.
You kill this many in that stack. So that gives you an option to kill
or maybe
off.
You add that many cards to your hand. So then you can have additional actions?
Add D20 cards
that's
to your
crazy.
I don't know,
that's
man. Try it out.
Jesus.
There's no bad ideas in brainstorming.
Well, I mean, there's at least one.
It's not that one.
No, okay. So I do like, okay, so they're serendipity. There are
20
cards in
each of
these stacks.
Really?
So the D20 will associate with that. I don't think there should be, I think maybe those are, you roll a D20, you get to add that many cards to your deck.
Okay.
Okay, and then we have to figure out the split between them.
Okay, we share.
Right.
Okay, cool.
So when do we use that D20, though? When does this get rolled? Does it get rolled when someone comes here? Like now he gets to roll for the Mallory cards?
Yeah, well, maybe probably when you guys kill one, then you roll it.
Every time we kill one? Or totally eradicate one?
Let's say eradicate. Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, so when you eradicate... you
which doesn't count the one that's already saved.
Right. Mm-hmm. So now this one is saved. So you would get a Mallory. So roll the D20.
But
would roll.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Because you have now saved Mallory.
So then these cards, what if they counted as double actions?
Double actions?
Yeah. So you know how I'm doing like that lets me move one. What if when I discard any one of these, it lets me I can discard one to move two.
So you get D20 double actions?
No. They go into your deck first.
Right.
They go into your deck. They get shuffled in. And then let's say I had a Cyril card, right?
Okay.
And I played him to move, then I'm going to move two times.
Okay.
And then when you guys use it, you're going to move two times.
Okay. That seems super swingy.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, we can try that.
Okay. I have one card left in there.
Shit!
Yeah! Yes! Oh!
I shouldn't even get a card.
The crit
yeah,
one.
No.
You have to give one of your cards back.
Yeah.
Okay. No, I'm just kidding. So you have now, so Mallory is gone. I think you get one Mallory card. D20, you got one card.
Mm-hmm.
So he rolled a one on his D20 roll.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah,
so it doesn't seem that OP.
Seems good.
As long as you roll a one, it doesn't seem that OP.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Say, Stopin, does that work? They wanted me to put the board.
Yeah.
Is that in the camera? It's good? In front of the timer? Shit. I'll move it. Okay.
What timer?
It's an overlay.
Oh.
All right.
We didn't even use this for attacking. There we go.
Okay.
All right. Things happen.
So we now have no reason to get rid of this, right? So we can just take it off
the
board.
Oh, because we can't get to the cards. All right.
Flight finds a way.
All right. Oh, you get, and you have scored one.
Yes.
All right. We're back to
so
our turns.
On our turn. Oh, I guess you know what? All right. Here you go.
Okay.
Four to Galactus. Because what am I
going
to
do? Can you do that?
Snap.
Oh, and then I have no cards. That'd be weird.
You have no cards in your deck.
Hmm.
I think
that'd be weird.
I think you can only do your only tribute to Galactus is from the killed cards.
That makes
kill
more
cards?
Sense.
So then, what
or
you...
just things that we've killed, just souls sacrificed to Galactus will come in.
Mm-hmm.
Can we actually get to? Well, I guess we could get to 10. You could. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Once these
but
start
then, but
this
seems
over.
Silly because now I'm here and I can move, right? And I'll just here. I'm assuming that's me. I have no idea anymore.
Yeah, that's fine.
One, two, and then I'll just.
So we need a way to attack you for circumstances like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we literally just we don't have anything to do.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What would you like to do?
I want to attack you.
You want to attack?
I want to attack you, and I think that attacking you should maybe you discard cards.
Okay.
I feel like I want to.
You
want to
look
something.
At? You want to look?
I
want
to look at things. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I want to look and see where things are.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Let's do that then. So you can can look.
Okay. I had an extra card.
All right. Now, when you look though, what can you do with that information? Is it just like you just know it?
She just knows. Yeah. How does that help the?
How does it help the overall objective?
Because there's three or four blanks in there, right?
Right.
So now she knows that that could either be a character or not a character.
Right, but what should she do with that information now that she has it?
Yeah, because I can't I can't reveal any characters. I can basically wait around for you to reveal characters. And so if me knowing if that is a character or not a character doesn't matter to what you're going to choose.
Okay, so what about this? I mean, it seems super wonky, right?
Right.
But you looked at this now, and you can decide if you want to switch it.
Oh.
Yeah.
There we go. There's something. After your reveal?
She looked at it, and now she's switched it. Or she can determine if she wants to switch it or not.
But you can't
look at the one you're switching from.
Correct.
Gotcha.
But if we get a lot of intel, then we'll know and we can put the right ones in.
That's super tricky.
Okay.
Flavor-wise, I don't know what that would entail.
Right. I have no idea.
I'm trying to think of a name for the action.
Let's do that.
Swap-a-rooney.
Swap-a-rooney. All right.
You can also swap-a-rooney.
Okay, I did the swap-a-rooney.
The swap-a-rooney.
Wait, don't share information.
We're a
team.
Together. It's cool.
Yeah, you're the loner that's
no longer in action, right?
No, Galactus? No, because it's just killing.
Yeah, Galactus. Well, he will be in action once he comes out. We gotta move him around.
And then we can use those cards as the things that he burns up.
I'm gonna give myself an action. It's called buy.
Okay.
So I can use two cards to buy one of those cards.
One of them. All right. Okay. Are you done with your? Finish your turn.
I have not taken my turn.
Okay, finish your turn, and then I'll shuffle these.
Putting all the good ones on the bottom.
Do I even want to go all the way down?
Does a double ego boost become a quad ego boost?
No, because you're still revealing
that's a lot
it.
Of ego.
You're still revealing it for the power.
So are we still incorporating a mechanic where you can attack? The players, or is that
so? Right now, we have no PvP.
Okay,
shuffle these.
Putting all the good ones on the bottom.
Do I even want to go all the way down?
Does a double ego boost become a quad ego boost?
No, because you're still revealing
that's a lot
it.
Of ego.
You're still revealing it for the power.
So, are we still incorporating a mechanic where you can attack the players, or is that
so? Right now, we have no PvP.
Okay,
you know what I just realized too? Is I'm doing this to move, and then I'm using the ego boost to boost that.
Right.
But that only moves me one extra one.
Right, that's what I was saying. You can only do one move a turn, but you said you don't want to do that.
Oh, right.
But now you want to?
I mean, it's up to you. You're the lead designer now.
Right, okay.
So the question is that the ego boosts are useful. We had the ego boosts are in the game. There's ego boosts, double ego boosts. Mm-hmm. And we were saying that you can use an ego boost when you make a move to boost your move.
Okay.
However, it doesn't really work if a card is also a move. Yeah. It just evens out.
How's about this? I move. That doesn't make sense.
If you just cut the boost entirely.
Yeah.
Because
the double boost is really helpful.
The double boost is what's helpful. And maybe maybe you have the card, and maybe you can only use your double boosts, and then that gives you like two cards for 3 points of action. Is that a thing? So like, let's say you use a move, and then you use your double boost. Mm-hmm. Now you can move three instead of two.
Okay.
But
what is the regular boost?
Just nothing.
So
I have no idea.
We do have it so that you can, when you see someone, you can boost and add extra tokens.
Mm-hmm.
Right? That's still what you want to do.
Oh, add more of the tokens of that character.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I feel like doing all the additional boosting is helpful because with the characters, not necessarily you specifically as the moving, it's getting the characters over there.
Yeah, that's the more probably efficacious usage. Mm-hmm.
So would quadruple boost be?
So no. So there's no quadruple boost, I think.
Okay, right? No quadruple boost. Okay.
Is that what? Because those are still actions.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. There's no.
Okay, because it's still one card that would be.
But you need to. How many ego boosts do you have? You have a lot.
The regular boost.
No.
Two.
I think they boost whatever action you're taking. It's the easiest thing to do.
So four and two double boosts.
Okay, yeah, I think that they boost whatever action you're taking, mm-hmm. so you're not going to want to use them with a move. Mm-hmm. However, they would be useful to spend when you flip up the right token, because you can add extra tokens.
Or move the characters double. Once you flip them over.
Or move them when you flip them over.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, like, you reveal it mm-hmm. with an action, and then ego boost to move them immediately, you know?
Okay.
Which
and play.
Oh, that makes. Second. Yeah, okay.
One. It's the same thing.
That gets the game started a little faster, too.
Did I just skip over this guy?
Yeah, you did. You were on top of him, like, previous turn.
I was?
Yeah.
If you have
I
a
don't
default,
know why you moved. I don't know why you moved.
I was here.
That's interesting.
So move.
I think.
Is there a d4 in here?
No, but there's a d8 divided by 2.
Reveal.
D divided by 2 could work.
Are you serious?
There might just be too many actions for this game.
Yeah, it's a lot. There's quite a few building up.
Mm-hmm. I love the D20. That's how many cards you.
That's a lot.
Someone in chat was saying that we recovered too easily from this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. It was too easy adding a.
Someone needs to make a harder wheel. I think.
We need to play test this wheel. Is what it is.
Mm-hmm. Or we got to see some more options on the wheel.
Yeah, this is our first usage of the wheel, so we'll work on that for next time.
More Sharkies. More people have to
more,
play this game.
More slots that say shark on them. Just half the wheel should say shark.
Because I mean, I'll be honest, like I'm looking at the wheel right now and there's a few things that are scary.
Yeah.
But I just, you know, if chat wants to see if we hit those, we can try to take them on. We have like a few minutes left.
We have a few minutes.
But I so far I think we've handled all of our challenges very well.
So yeah. They're saying somebody else has a 1d4 in here.
But
1d4.
Oh yeah, in previous episodes we've had like a jar full of dice, which makes the add d20 a strange thing to.
That is a mandatory add d20.
Oh, that's true.
All right, so
divided by two.
No. Let's just keep it the way it is.
Okay.
Whose turn is it?
I revealed. That was my.
And
turn.
There
was a blank.
There.
There was nothing.
Yes. Okay, so now we have this interesting thing where I'm this one, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I'm. I don't know why we don't really need cards. We will need cards eventually.
We can only take 4 actions. That's the thing, is like we can only take 4
but
actions.
We will need cards because we're going to be getting double actions with our d20s.
Got it. And that one or this one?
There we go. I just thought of that. So buy with boost. You can only buy with boost. Because I didn't buy ones.
Oh, so the ego boosts are the ones that let you buy the cards.
Yeah.
Okay.
Makes them a reason for them existing.
Right.
Cool. Additional reason. All right, so I looked at this one, mm-hmm. Nicole, and I swapped it with this one.
Okay.
Isaiah, turn around.
All right, cool.
All right. Makes them a reason for them existing.
Right.
Cool.
Okay.
Additional reason. Mm-hmm. All right, so I looked at this one, mm-hmm. Nicole, and I swapped it with this one.
Okay.
Isaiah, turn around. This is a super lonely. This is one of those rare three-player only games, and like it's literally like we should call this a third wheel.
The third wheel.
Because really, it's like me and Nicole are like cooperating, and we're like, I just go in the other room while we take our turn.
Yeah, yeah. This is like very kind of ostracizing.
Yeah,
right.
Weird. Maybe we could do a sex sandwich.
If you know, I know you're upset, but if you ever mention my mother's loins or their frothiness again. When will you not suck at this?
I don't know.
I assume that smell is cabbage and not just you two.
Okay.
Awesome. All right, I don't know what that was doing because I could swap a Rony.
Mm-hmm.
No, I've already, wait, is that the one I looked at? That's the one I looked at, I'm sorry. So we're moving, oh my god, here. And that's the one you just swapped.
No, I swapped this one with this one.
Okay, and
This is excellent. You guys have the worst memory.
I know.
I really do have that.
I know. Well, now it's just becoming this weird memory keep away from you, but then we also have to remember where we put things.
We need you to reveal some people so we can get Galactus out.
That's the thing is that swapping mechanic makes it harder for him to reveal stuff, and the game doesn't really start until things start getting revealed.
That's true.
Yeah, because we came in.
Yeah, no one can do anything until these little things pop out.
Bye, Swapperoni.
So what if we can look at the tokens and choose to reveal them?
I would like that actually, because then if that's the thing that's really the catalyst that makes this game start, maybe. Because
then you can force to reveal over here and just kill them all before he gets a chance to get over.
And that way, if he's turtling, it's like, all right, cool, we're just gonna go over here and kill all your dudes.
Should make it more difficult for us to reveal? Is that a problem, or so we can't just like blow up? So we can't just like turtle in a spot, blow up free, you know?
I don't think it needs to be more difficult for us to reveal, because if it's we're getting like, you know, we're gonna be getting. One, two, you know, most spots are going to be in multiples, like four or five people. And we really have a limited number of actions, right? We have four actions.
Okay. Everyone's cool with it, I'm going to try with that new thing of revealing.
Sure.
I am so cool with that.
All right, and I don't remember where I was.
So then,
but right here.
We're both doing move reveal. Except you do move reveal kill.
Right. And in a way, like, revealing also gives you the potential to, gives you the potential to score because we're actually doing one new.
I revealed a blank, so.
Okay.
I think it's an interesting tension.
Yeah, I like that we have a choice. We can look and we can choose to reveal or not.
Yeah.
And so does he think that it's like. Mm-hmm.
Like you could have looked and saw the blank and just left it there.
Right. Yeah.
Well, that's then he would kind of know. He would kind of assume it was a blank. Or maybe
wouldn't I just assume that it's
That's kind of what we've had though, is basically we do that same thing, we just put it back, and then it doesn't actually accelerate the game for us either.
Right.
Yeah.
It's an obligatory reveal.
No, but if we look at it though, like, and it's something that we want to reveal, we can reveal it. I mean, it gives us a way to sort of skirt the game towards its inevitable conclusion. Because by the way, we do want to reveal these because if we get 10, we get Galactus out, and that's how we
really. That's the only way that we get him out is by actually killing these things that are running around.
Okay.
All right. Well, I did my turn. I did my four things. I revealed one. I moved. And that's back.
All right, your turn.
I'm gonna ego boost and buy a card. And I'm gonna move.
Cost you one ego boost to buy a card?
Yes.
Okay.
One, two. And you guys already swapped that guy, right?
I don't recall.
Maybe.
Reveal. Okay. Cyril Figgis.
Damn that Cyril. How many do you need?
Two more?
Yeah. It does have this sort of weird...
No, one more.
The balancing is just
so I remember
crazy.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
But
what
this
was
is,
it? Was it that one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There's this weird point because... The cards that you're getting are rewards for doing awesome things, but it also could lead to a little bit of runaway if he gets like 20 double actions and all of a sudden he's like boom, 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 going crazy. But I mean, we have to see it.
Right.
So we are rolling 1d20. All right,
I'm done.
Your turn over?
I think that's his turn,
yeah.
So this token right here goes away, correct?
Yeah.
Is it replaced with a serial token? It should, right?
It should.
Sure. Okay.
All right, my turn. All
right, let's blow up some Cyrils.
Two. Three. Four. I'm gonna play a little defense if you wanna go.
Yeah, I'm gonna go appropriately named on.
We missed a Cyril.
Oh.
But it spawned from here, right? Oh, here, okay.
Oh, yep, you're right. Oh.
Thanks.
Good looking.
Sharp.
Yeah.
Good looking.
All right, I'm gonna go on a rampage. Load one Cyril. There. Let's load that extra Cyril. Yeah.
All right.
Very productive turn.
Galactus is coming out. Soon.
Soon.
Yeah.
Soon.
Pretty fast.
Two,
soon.
Four, six, four more until Galactus comes out.
Me, right?
Yep.
Oh yeah, for those that don't know, as we are killing people, Galactus is basically just eating them.
Yeah, so, we're feeding him the souls. Zombie Galactus.
Yeah,
I'm gonna
move
and double ego boost these guys. So that's one, two, three. Right?
Sure.
No!
Is that even a spot?
Yeah.
It is!
It's a little island out there.
The arbor!
Okay.
Interesting.
And then I'm gonna do...
This dude's on my spot right now.
Move these guys.
Okay.
So you're gonna move, attack, move. So you can't do it. Got it.
So, all right.
See what I did there?
Yeah. Some strategic. See what you did there.
So my turn. Move. Attack. Mm-hmm. Can you move into a location that I'm in?
We had that happen previously where I was in. Before. Yeah.
Do you think I shouldn't? Because then you can just sit on top of
That's true. Mm-hmm. We should figure out.
They're ground units, we're air units. I think that's fair. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I can't get there. I can't. I don't think I can stop. I can make it go a long way though. So, well, no, either way, it's 1-2 for you to get there.
Mm-hmm. It's not gonna make it.
It might have to be that, like, your the movement points that you're getting aren't for everyone, maybe. Or they can't be boosted. You can't boost the moves of
the minions.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think, like, mathematically, if 5 pop up, mm-hmm. that would take us. If we're right there, it takes us 1, 2, 3, 4. We can kill 2 a turn. Like it's
right.
You're just like dumping all your cards to move.
Mm-hmm. You revealed.
I looked. Do I look and reveal?
You look. You can reveal.
You may reveal.
To. I'll leave it there.
Okay.
I will move.
But in fairness, I mean, you haven't won yet, so I could be.
Yeah, I'm way behind you guys. I don't know why you keep trying to hang.
You're 25% to the victory.
Yeah, yeah. You're...
0 to victory.
51%?
No, to getting Galactus. We don't win if Galactus comes out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're going to roll a d8, and then he goes on a certain section and starts
And
there.
Kills everyone there.
In that section. And then moves.
Okay. That's the end of the game for me at that point.
No, not necessarily. Like, right, we'll see. Not necessarily.
We'll see.
We haven't figured that out yet, though.
All right. Your turn. Your turn.
I'm done.
I got to move this guy, right? So move... Right?
Okay.
Wait, what'd you move to?
Oh, Rust Dreamer's going away. Oh, bye.
2 spots,
thanks for joining us.
Oh, okay.
There's no line there. 2
and
spots.
And you're saying I can't boost him?
You can move him again, though.
Let's see, that's 1.
It's flagrant. You came through my space.
Breaking all the rules.
17! Jesus!
That right. balances out.
Where's this at? Break room?
Yeah.
I don't know who that person is.
Cyril.
Is that Cyril? Oh, Cyril, right.
Cyril Face.
Cyril.
8, 9. So you get these cards out of your deck and they're double actions?
Yeah.
Seems pretty good.
Yeah, it seems like we should bring out Galactus and start burning all the other characters, right. And it's totally fair again.
So this lets me move twice, right?
Yeah. This game, I mean, it has a quick playtime, which is nice.
Yeah.
Except the fact that, like, sorting the cards takes long. It's gonna take longer than the game.
Juked. Yes, it worked. That was a false trail.
Wait.
Shouldn't he stay out so you guys? Can
I
kill
guess
him?
So. Yeah, that makes sense. She would have stayed out too. Mm-hmm. Good point. So we can still kill him. He's in the arbor.
Yeah, he's hanging out there.
All right, our turns.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to look here.
One of you should go after Cyril.
It's just 1 point. If they flip a thing, then maybe there's more points open up, you know.
Don't give them.
You're right.
Right?
I can't be picking sides.
How much time do we have left?
We have about 10 minutes left.
10 minutes.
Alright.
I think we got most of the game.
Yeah,
most of the game right
red.
Now.
You could still mess up the game, right, by donating.
They could still mess up the game by donating.
No. $25.
Spin that.
Spin the wheel. You can have us.
What's the worst possible scenario? Okay.
I think penis only.
What?
No, it's pens
only.
God.
Penis only.
Penis only. Yeah, I don't know how I would play that game.
Tough. I don't know how Isaiah would play that game.
All right, I'm going to reveal. Oop. So we're going to get a whole bunch of. I totally forgot this guy's name.
So, for. Can we take our actions? Do I have to take all mine and she takes all hers?
So let's see what all happens.
Yeah.
This goes here.
Okay.
This goes here.
But we either one of us can start.
Right.
That goes there. Oh, that's a.
Although I see what you're saying.
He's gonna get away.
I see what you're saying.
He's gonna get away with that. He's just gonna win.
But why would you want to
do that? No, I can do this. This would be fine.
Why would you want to do that?
Because like she could have looked and revealed, and I can go and clean up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess, yeah.
Because she was on top of it already?
Yeah.
Phrasing.
Are we still doing phrasing?
Yeah, we're still doing
phrasing. Okay, we should always do phrasing.
Is that you have to say it? I don't know what phrasing is. Don't put it there.
Oh, I'm sorry. Date. Oh, yeah, we totally. Let's
see. It's an archer.
4, 6, 8.
It's like when you say something and it's phrased.
Oh, man, sexually. I can't blow up another thing that was maybe inefficient.
So what if... I'm going to throw in more rules.
Okay. Because why not? Sure.
What if we can actually spend these as well for extra actions?
No. Come on.
We only ever have 4 actions the entire game.
Yeah, but the goal of the game is to get...
That's true.
10 of these in there.
It's not the goal.
Why
the goal,
would you be burning there?
In a case like this where we don't want you to just escape with him and get closer to victory.
Right. But with two more kills... I think 1 or 2 more kills, this guy's gonna come out.
Yeah.
Actually, now that I think about it, we can't really do that. Because you could spend 1 right now, kill it, and you get it back.
Right. So,
yeah. Too much crosstalk.
No, I just wanted to hit the button.
Oh, okay.
How's it going, guys?
Terrible. Good. It's going good.
Yeah, well, he's
good, terrible.
Yeah.
He's another player.
You're just sad that you're no longer in the shark suit.
It was so hot in there. It was ridiculous.
We need to, air condition it or something.
It was great to see him shuffle that out.
Open the butt flaps.
That's what I'm gonna say. We'll cut some ventilation in the armpits, get that mashed in a little zipper so you can open and close when it's like...
That'd be good.
When you're skiing in it.
Nice air conditioned shark.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So how's the game coming along?
It's actually not bad, to be honest.
Yeah.
It's
workable.
Just about every week, last week aside, we are surprised by how good these games end up being.
Well, it's not good.
No, yeah, we say it's good.
Yeah.
How much potential these games end up having.
Yes.
I honestly think this game does have potential. I think that if you were able to figure out a better way to use these cards, and so that it actually has that deck builder feel.
Right, yeah.
I think even the chat mentioned it, deck builder plus a board. Like something like Trains or something like that is a really fun deck builder because it has
Web of
extra
Spies.
Element. Web of Spies.
Venom Assault was the game that I forgot to mention was a thing like that where you're basically G.I. Joe agents going to individual places and using your cards to defeat certain enemies.
Yeah, so if we had time to develop that mechanic, I think that there could be, it could really start to sing. As it is though, it functions.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I feel like there are some decisions being made, which is nice.
I mean, there's definitely things that, obviously we would change if we wanted to, because I think one of the limitations is us only having 4 actions and it being the same actions the entire game is kind of really boring.
Yeah.
Even if it is very unfair to you because we can do work so well together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
After a while it just gets stagnant.
But
yeah, it works. That's the great part. It works.
That's always a plus. Mm-hmm. It's always a plus. Say an escapee, add gills to the suit. I like this plan. I don't know how well it'll work for ventilation, but.
There's a cool little deception kind of mechanic in here with the blanks and be able to swap things or look at them and put them back. So that's nice too.
Yeah, we got rid of Swap-a-Rooney. No more Swap-a-Rooney. But we can reveal or just choose to put it back, which did actually work to fool Isaiah. So I'm done. That goal accomplished.
All right. Well, cool. You guys have just a little bit more time to finalize anything you want to finalize, and then we'll bring people on out to play it. So
cool. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Hurry up.
All right. So, as it stands right now, I think the biggest issue is that having these locations here makes it relatively easy for you to get to your victory condition. Because your victory condition, remember, is to get 4
unique tokens.
And you're on your turn, you're going to get 3, right? And it's very difficult for us to actually eradicate them. So I think that what needs to happen is maybe you don't have the full pandemic spread. Mm-hmm. You maybe get 1 plus 1 more or 2 more, so for 3 total. And then you can use your boosts to put more.
What is pandemic do? 3?
Well, pandemic and outbreak, you get 1 on every adjacent, which is what we've been doing.
Right. Yeah. Or you could just have the bases spawn a little farther from the end point.
True.
That could be a thing.
Yeah, it's actually interesting, and I don't think we're going to continue playing, because this one is a blank, and this one is a blank, and he's right there.
Yeah,
so once he does bank that, he's going to have to go pretty far to get to the rest.
Right.
And by that point, then we're gonna we might have Galactus out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
and he has enough double boost to kind of counter some of that. But yeah.
Yeah. So it's hard to tell from like, you know, the 1.5 plays that we've done. Yeah. Or I guess the 2.5 plays that we've done. Mm-hmm. But that would be my biggest fear is just trying to figure that out. And then what Nicole was saying is that we have 4 actions and we're gonna send every turn. We will start getting eventually when we eradicate something. We'll get a D20's worth of double actions.
Yeah, all right.
But even that though, like, that is a very baseline.
All right. Thing. Well, let's. We have a few minutes. Do we want to change that D20 worth of cards thing right now? Because it is silly. I got 17 double action cards, right?
Yeah. But you can still only draw 4, right?
All
right.
What about this?
Still only draw 4.
Every turn, you roll a D20. Mm-hmm. If you get equal to or under the amount of heads that Galactus has there, that's when he comes out.
Oh, shit. I love
so,
it.
Equal to.
Or under. Okay. So the more heads that are coming the out, more chances. The more likelihood that Galactus is going to come out.
Okay. But you could roll a 1.
Like that's exciting.
First roll.
Could. Mm-hmm. And Galactus comes out. I mean, maybe we just make him less powerful. Maybe he hits 1 location, mm-hmm. pops back out.
Okay. Pops in out. Okay.
I like that.
Right, and that way we're not getting all these double cards.
Yeah.
One thing I was gonna say though, so like, when I'm actually designing games that I want to design, uh-huh. sometimes I will have like a half an idea that I think is really good. Like I think this is really good, mm-hmm. and I will just outright steal another mechanic from a different game, tack it on, and use it as a placeholder.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Because like what we were saying before is like playing through kind of what we're doing. We're playstorming this game.
Yeah.
Like we're figuring out all those problems, so we know that this is gonna be updated and refined, mm-hmm. but what we have now works, and so that's kind of
gotcha. So you build a game like piecemeal,
mm-hmm. right?
Yeah,
right. Because really, what you're trying to do, like my whole mantra is start trying to play the game as quickly as you can, because mm-hmm. that's when you see where it really breaks down. Mm-hmm. If you're sitting with it in your head or on paper,
you can just speculate like, all day.
You can speculate all day.
Yeah.
Okay. Ideas are a dime a dozen, right? Everyone sure. has ideas, but it's really about doing it and then the execution and doing it. Mm-hmm. So. This is basically what we sit and do, at least at my office. We try to play a game every day or every couple of days, but we play the prototype. We say we need to change these 2 or 3 things, and then we change the PMP files. We print it out and we play it again. So this would be like one afternoon that me and Dave are doing. So this is game design. If you want to get into game development, it's playing a bunch of shitty games over and over again until you have something passable. Yeah. And then you show it to people, and then they tell you it's broken.
Mm-hmm. And they tell you all the things. Yeah. All the things to fix that you've already tried to fix that same way, and then you try it again.
You start paying for art too early, and then your Kickstarter fails. And it's fun, actually. It's really
it's
good.
A lot of good times.
It's so good.
Do we need to do like a one final recap? Or
we'll get that, everyone in here, the players, them? And then we'll teach them with that recap. Joe, I think we're ready to bring in our players. All right.
I would say though, my job is fun. Like,
it's
super amazing, and just creating something, I think, is one of the single best things that you can do in your life.
For sure.
Right? It's like just create something, get
show
it out
game,
there.
I want to see your game.
I was into this whole monologue. wait, let me get off my soapbox.
Okay, wait. No, I'll stop. Sorry, I don't know what was happening. Do it. Make it happen.
I was just trying to say that creating stuff and designing games is awesome. And
I agree.
It's one of the number one things I think anyone should do with their lives.
Yeah, do it. Okay.
Okay, we have 3 players.
You said you needed high.
This music is perfect, by the way. So
the camera can't see you.
We're still doing buy with the boost, right?
Yep.
But I can only buy 1 card and it's a double.
All right.
So none
someone's,
of this really
someone's gonna be.
They're just
gonna
buy
fighter.
One.
Be there you go. All right. Those are gonna be your starting cards. Those are your only cards. Actually.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll go too crazy into it.
What is the title of this game?
Oh, it is Danger Thrones.
Danger
Thrones.
Danger Thrones.
All right. In this game, you have a rebel player, a single player,
okay,
and then you have 2 empire players.
Okay.
All right, so it's 2 versus 1. The it's so hot in here. So the rebel player's job
I don't
is
think
going
ventilation
to be.
Gonna help either.
You're gonna get however many cards you have of actions, okay?
Okay.
And so the rebel's goal is to move to these blue chips and reveal them as one of their actions. And if it happens to be one of the numbers up here, so this happens to be, what is her name again? Cheryl? Oh, but they keep naming Carol.
Cheryl.
Just kidding. So then what that would happen is, it's kind of like pandemic, so it would bloom.
Okay.
But we're doing three now?
Yep.
So adjacent to this, three Carols or Cheryls would show up. Mm-hmm. And so then your job is to get these, any one of these, over to this base where you started.
Okay.
Okay, once you have at least four unique characters banked, then you win the game.
Okay.
So now the Empire is trying to prevent that, right? So the Empire, what they're going to do is also they're going to move. They're going to be able to kill these tokens.
Okay.
They're also going to be able to look, and they may reveal. You don't have to. So the point of that is that you can try to throw someone off. So this one's blank, right? So you can look at it, and you're going to like leave it there. So that
makes
tells
some kind of interesting poker face.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So that tells the rebellion player, like, oh, I don't think this is really worth anything. Or you can just hide something there is worth something, but you're throwing them off the trail.
Okay.
So they can move, they can kill, they can, no, the actions are there. Look and may reveal. Okay.
Yeah, the rebels. Limit, yeah, the limiting thing for the Empire is they only have the four actions.
Okay.
So yeah, you're only the four cards. Sorry. So you can only take four actions.
So who wants to be the rebel player?
The shark. Yeah. Shark should always be the rebel player.
Okay. So the rebel player can move. They can reveal one of these, like I just did here, as an action. And the way you do it is you're gonna, it's like a deck building game. You're gonna draw four cards. And these are the four actions that you can take.
Yes.
It was hard for me to do. So these are the cards you would have. If they don't, all we're paying attention to is these keywords here, right? So there's two blanks. There is one boost. And then there's a double boost. The boost you can use to discard and show to buy one of these. And any one of these, it doesn't actually, we can just get rid of them.
All of them, right?
So you can use a boost to buy a card, and that will go into your discards, and that gives you chances to get more boosts and more double boosts. Okay. You can use a card to move, so you would discard it face down to move. You can then double boost it if you want. That's what the double boost is for. So you would reveal your double boost, and that will let you move two more times.
Okay.
Okay. So you're basically just trying to get to these blue chips, reveal them, spawn out the other, the red chips over there of those characters, and then move those characters over to your base.
Okay.
Oh, and what we forgot to mention is the rebels, right? The rebel, no, not the rebels, sorry.
Empire.
The Empire. The Empire, when they kill the kind of the spawn that are gonna be here, everyone that you kill is gonna go as a token towards Galactus.
Zombie Galactus.
You'll be feeding Zombie Galactus, and after you get 10 of them, you roll a die, and he's gonna randomly spawn in an area.
Nice.
And
we changed that rule.
Oh, we did change that rule? Yep. Crap.
At the end of every turn, you're gonna roll this d20.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you get less than the number of heads that are in front of Zombie Galactus, he will come out.
So right now you would roll,
at the end of each turn.
Okay. It's a 12. He only has, zero heads in front of him.
Okay.
So you would
well,
not
rolling
spawn.
Rolling low is not going for this game.
Got it. Okay.
Okay. So your goal is to try to kill as many heads.
We're gonna win! Dun 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 dun
dun dun dun. So there's three players and only one rebel and two.
It's one versus two, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's called the game of the third wheel.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna have like a great time together and you're gonna be the
opposite. So our goal is to prevent
her. So life is normal. Got it.
From getting the chips over here.
Mm-hmm.
How do we win? By getting all the chips?
You are trying to eradicate four of those characters.
Exterminate.
So if you can exterminate them completely before they escape, you get to collect their head.
Okay.
And if you get four of them, you win.
All right.
Galactus, when Galactus comes out, goes to a colored area of the board and then kills everyone there. He's the only way that you can kill someone who is not revealed yet.
Okay.
Teamwork.
So I want Galactus to not show up.
Revealed one
of yes. But there's not much you can do to stop it. So it's inevitable. You have to race to accomplish your goal before Galactus shows up, is what your goal is.
Okay.
Am I a little difficult to take seriously right now?
A little bit.
Yeah, we didn't know until we played it either.
But did you have a good time?
It was just two insults and two blanks.
For what? For ours?
Yeah, for the Empire.
We only have insults.
Yeah. There's no judgment happening.
Four insults.
I don't know where the other four insults are. You threw all the cards willy-nilly to the ether.
Do you have any cards?
No, I only have Westeros cards.
Yeah,
I gave up all my cards. Double deuce. Oh, I gave her cards. I'm sorry.
Oh,
she has it. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm prepared.
So these are your cards.
Mine?
They're just kind of action markers.
Do we share them?
No, you have four of your cards.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. They don't actually do anything for you. They're just to track your actions. So you get four actions.
Okay.
These you would shuffle, and you would take four.
Maybe Dan can be in.
That's your hand of cards. There. That's
a way to do it.
Mm-hmm. That thing you just did. Okay.
This is gonna be very interesting.
All right, so
I'm being very sneaky.
You get to go first.
You get to go first, right?
All right. So the cards that don't have boost or double boost, I turn in
as actions. Correct.
As actions, yeah.
In an attempt to get a boost or a double boost. Are those, so a boost lets me move an extra one, or I can
a
move without
a boost?
A boost
lets you buy a card.
Okay.
And these cards, so they're the PAM cards, are going to give you double action.
Okay.
So when you use the PAM card to move, you're going to be able to move two times.
Okay. But otherwise, I can just move once.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. All your cards can be discarded as actions.
Right.
Your boosts have additional abilities.
Alright.
Okay.
Let's walk through one round.
Yeah.
Like, you guys can help us out, make sure we're doing it right,
mm-hmm.
and then we'll see if we can do it.
So, the logical step is for me to go to one of these
blues
first, yeah. right? Because I can get there from here. Stop judging me. And what does that do to this token?
So that would have cost you one
card.
Which
one discard.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Doing three. We're still doing blooming
you can move
everywhere, right?
Three different
tokens.
Is that
tokens how it goes?
So. Okay.
What do you want to do?
One space.
Bloom.
All
I like
those
chaos,
tokens, one space.
Yeah.
And I need to get them back to...
to the base.
I mean, obviously
okay.
it's kind of...
So it makes sense
right
for me
there,
to spend
you guys are close enough to
a card to grab all three of those and move back to my base. Is that two?
It just has to be adjacent where
you
can field it.
You can use one to move them all one space,
yeah.
and then another one to move them all another. Three different tokens.
Is that
tokens
how it goes?
Okay.
What do you want to do?
One space.
Bloom.
All
I like
three
more
of those
chaos,
tokens,
more
one
things.
Space.
Yeah.
And I need to get them back to...
to the base.
I mean, obviously
okay.
it's kind of...
So it makes sense
right
for me
there,
to spend
you guys are close enough to
a
just,
card
you know,
to grab all three
yeah.
of those and move back to my base. Is that two?
It just has to be adjacent where you can field it.
You can use one to move them all one space, and then another one to move them all another space.
Okay, so I could use one card to move all of those heads to my base, which is one space away.
Right.
Okay.
Is it one space
away? Well, I only moved one. Where's...
Oh.
Is my base not where I just came from?
Okay, so one is connected, yeah.
Okay, so I will spend one more action and do that.
Okay.
All right.
So then you
I already
choose,
broke the game.
You
cool.
backed one.
Oh, now, it's only one.
And
that's
now you can move. So you want to try to move these probably away from them because they can still kill them and feed Galacticus, who's then going to help them.
So I can only
roll
take
better.
One.
You only need to
yeah,
take
you
one.
Only
you
need
only
one.
Need to take one.
Okay.
You just need one unique. Because
you win when you have four unique.
Got
heads.
It. Okay. So but I don't want them to die because they feed zombie Galacticus.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
This is
nice. But I do want to move them so I can spend another one and move them all.
Well, when
one
you spend
step
a card,
away.
You'll move all of the heads, not just the one.
You're trying so hard not to laugh at me.
Yes.
I think we all are.
so you
every
can
time
move
you
all
do
the
that,
heads
you match
still.
The shark emote.
Yeah.
It's just the best.
It's brilliant.
We're trying to be really
so there's
serious
the,
here.
There's the last one. I know, game, serious business.
So you still have your two actions. So you can actually still, you can like reveal
no,
this one.
Have two.
Isn't she?
She moved, revealed,
yeah.
moved.
Oh, you're right. One more. So you can move one more space.
Okay, did it not just cost that to? Oh, wait, okay, I get it.
So you
all right. So
move,
I can
reveal,
move one
move.
More space.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I can't push them all away again because I just did that. And that now they're
you
not with me.
Push them all away. You can.
You could.
That's all right. We'll feed Zombie Galactus.
Okay.
I'm not that competitive today, and I'm gonna move to here. Then.
All right.
All right. So yes. Our next move.
Who goes first? Do we move? Do we move together as a team?
Yeah.
Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors. Go.
Tank.
Okay. She had it down like full half second.
Yeah. Oh,
rock. Rock. Rock always wins.
Tank.
Rock. All right, I won. Okay, so now.
Just exploring, don't mind me.
So I play one of these, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
To make a move.
Perfect.
So then I take one of these. Hello.
Close this.
Stay in your spot. Hey. Stay
you
there.
Move it upside down, up and down.
You're
all right, so then I want to get these, right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Seriously.
I can move one space because of this,
yeah.
Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Need to.
So I'm usually really slow to catch on to board games, to be completely honest.
That's
so,
your
so now, how do I take?
To kill a dude, it would take a card.
Done.
So
boom.
Wrecked. If you didn't.
How did you move two?
So oh, sorry. I go
to get all the way to the green, you'd need two cards.
Oh.
Yeah, so it's move, and then you can go.
Move again.
There you go.
Got him.
And then you got him. Cool. And then he goes to Galactus. There you go.
Here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Human tastes good.
And then I do another thing. Roll the dice. Do I have to do another?
Not yet. You do get one more action.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So you can kind of like move yourself in the strategic area to like cut someone off.
I'm moving that way.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And now you'll take your four actions.
All right. So to move, I have to play a card, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yeah.
And that's like one card per?
Yeah.
So one, two, three to get to there.
Mm-hmm.
And then I use another card to
kill me.
What about reveal? Do I automatically reveal it or spend an action?
You can spend an action to reveal or to look at it, and then you may flip it over if you want.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm just gonna kill the
okay.
Meow.
Right. So
it's the end of the turn. One of you rolls a dice. You get a one.
Or a two. No, just a one.
Less, yeah. So one.
Close.
The Galactus is
so
not.
Close.
I get really low engagement.
Mm-hmm. So now it's your turn again.
It's your turn again. I have drawn your hand for you.
Thank you. All right, so I'm on a spot that has one.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll spend one to reveal.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm very impressed that you're
I got this.
Very
I totally got fits. This.
Cause there's another.
Two.
That's two.
Wait, can people still donate $25 to add something to the game?
Oh God!
If we hold
no,
the wheel.
But we should have a separate wheel for
uh-huh.
after
uh-huh.
when we're playing the game, perhaps.
That okay. sounds terrifying, chat. I want to hear your ideas for how you guys can mess with us next week during this section.
Mm-hmm.
There's gotta be a way, and you're smart
well,
people, and I know you've got that in you.
We also have four Kigurumis. This is the shark costume, but we also have four Kigurumis.
Do you have a unicorn?
We do have two unicorns.
We have two unicorns and two
just because you can't have just
things.
One unicorn. Yes.
All right, so I get a face,
no
right?
Are talking about.
Or I have to pay an action.
The full suit things.
This.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's called like
essentially,
it's
yeah.
It's what hip kids wear.
They're supposed
a little
to
bit
be
different.
Cuter. One more.
Yeah.
I couldn't find one.
Tip to confuse.
Kind of just no.
They don't see.
They don't have the weird like face part.
Oh.
They have hoods. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
And they're made of fleece instead of whatever this weird.
So you get the rest of your actions.
Okay, so I, in order to grab one and move them all away, I spend one more action.
Well, now you want to get Pam's?
The lady face.
Pam, Lana. You want to get Lana over to your base,
right?
Because that's going to give you a victory point. And you can also move the other ones.
Sure.
Out of the way.
How do I do that?
You spend a card to move. And
oh wait, that one's a boost.
Yeah, it's a boost.
So that gives me an extra move, or
mm-hmm.
no?
No, they're all boosts, so it doesn't matter. The boost you spend to buy a card.
Okay, so I'll buy a card.
Mm-hmm. But it's discarded.
And okay.
It'll get shuffled in later.
And so that spends the move?
No, because you just use this card just to buy.
That's like the deck building element.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
so
then I guess I'm doing that again and again.
Well, so what you want to do is you want to move your hero head dudes back to the base to get to claim that person before they kill them all, because that's your victory points, is you want to get four of those.
But I can't because all I have is boosts.
So all of your cards can be used for actions, mm-hmm. and then in addition to that, your ego boosts have additional abilities.
Got it.
So you may use it as an action or as an ego boost.
Okay, so that second one... No, that's fine.
Okay.
To do that. So that one is the one that I'll use as an action.
To move.
To move.
Mm-hmm.
And to move.
You get to move all of one type of token, one space.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Okay.
Well,
I need to pull one of those back to my base.
So that one will score you. That puts you halfway to victory.
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then I can just move the other ones away.
Mm-hmm.
Away.
Or you can also move those towards your base, because that means if they go into the base and they're safe and they don't get eaten by...
Well, why did the dude faces go in the wrong direction then? Jeez.
That was your...
All right, so this one can move one, and that goes into the base too.
I have this strange feeling like opposable
and this
thumbs
can go.
This one, right, this is a connector. But
you are mistaken. Oh, all right.
Wants a challenge.
Well, I'll push it this way instead because this one does connect.
Okay.
And then I'll push this one. Can they both be on the same?
Sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So that goes there. That goes there. This one goes there. Can I move both of those or just the lady face?
Just the lady face.
All right. That's her name. Don't judge me.
It's Lana.
Whatever. Lana. It's Lady Face.
Danger Throne.
Whatever her first name is, her last name is Lady Face. Yep. So.
So yeah, you're doing really good right now. Halfway to victory. Mm-hmm.
Cool.
You still have a card in your hand.
So what are the? What's the advantage of having the cards that don't have the boost on them?
They're not. They are less.
Less good than your boost.
You have more of those than you have boosts.
So then why would I ever pull more cards? Because I get more actions next turn?
Why would you ever what?
Why would I ever use these to pull
those are worth double. Card.
These are double actions. These are actually better than...
Yeah. That would give you two moves if you played that.
Okay.
Double review?
Sure. Sure. So I'll spend this to move over to King's Landing.
Oh yeah, actually it is Lana Monster Hands. As chat...
It's true. That's true. Mm-hmm.
Guys, why you gotta be picky?
All right.
Okay.
So you draw your new hand.
There's no way for me to attack, right?
No.
Okay. One of the racing
just checking.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna.
That's a good question, though. If I was playtesting this, I'd write that down.
One thing you could do is you can check this base, reveal it if it is a thing, and then start. Clean up killing little dudes.
Sure.
And then your partner can fly over and try and kill a little more. But if you can reveal it in a place that's farther enough away from the home base that they can't get there quickly.
Right.
So that gives you an advantage when you reveal.
So could we come down here?
I mean, it'll take you a while to get there, but yeah, I mean, there's other things to kill here too.
I can spread off over here and then you can get the north.
Strategy. All
right. This is the south. This is the north.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's flipped.
Whatever.
This is the north. Okay. So I'm gonna.
It's short.
I'm gonna action.
All right, to look at that token.
To look at this token right here.
And you don't show the shark.
Not too bad. Your head's on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you may reveal it.
But yeah.
Sure. If it's a number, you want to reveal it.
A little bit. Or you could just install a fan in there.
Okay, it's gonna stay there, guys.
Even the wizard brain comes out on microphones.
Shh.
Oh.
Okay. So you still
I want them to hear me. I don't want you to hear me.
So you can still do the same thing, and you can check here.
I'm sorry. Say that again.
So you can. You still have your three actions.
Yes.
So you can move there and check that one if you want to check that one.
Done.
It would cost you two cards to do
that. Doing it. Okay. Learned. I learned things.
Say hypothetically, someone would fire them. Get them just picked up.
If you could hear it.
Okay. Yeah. And now I have one more action.
Then it would just be
a noise. Okay. Do I want to reveal? I can
I'm asking for
kill another of these.
Well, the real key, right, is you just don't.
But really what I would want to do is get Lana, right? Mm-hmm. Because, nope, she's already got them, so that doesn't matter. What's the best strategy here?
So, what is underneath here? Okay. So, what I would do is I would move So you have a few turns because she's going to be spending time trying to heal those. I would move here and then start clearing these up.
Okay. You guys have a fog machine?
Feeding
Lactus. I would use that all the time.
Oh no!
Oh no!
I did it again!
Oops, she did it again.
That's the second Britney Spears thing I've done today.
Play with the miniature.
Okay.
The first was shaving your head?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes. And I also took an umbrella and slammed it on Zach. Okay.
Yeah.
Your turn.
That classic Britney Spears.
I know.
My classic Britney Spears was slamming people with umbrellas.
I did a little dance while I did it.
I'll spend one to reveal a disc.
Okay.
What are the rules for me peeking when she looks?
That's against the rules.
Yeah, you can't peek.
That's cheating.
There's a strict no peek law.
You have a few actions left. So what you can do, if you reveal it, there will be tokens that are placed out around that area. And then you'll basically have to clear them.
Okay. Let's do it.
Do it?
All right. The four.
Find these heads. These beard heads.
Oh no, this works too. They have two sides.
And
that's all of them.
Alright. So you have how many actions left?
Three.
Okay, so
eat them.
You're gonna want to get rid of this one for sure.
Yeah.
Because he's right there. So
that's two to get there.
So two to get there. Before you leave this space, do you wanna take him out?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then go one
Feed
more,
him
one
to
move.
Our zombie overlord.
Oh, you know what you guys haven't done now? Now it's the end of their turn. They can roll the d4, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah!
So
they did have first turn. Oh,
so okay. Now you roll, you need a three or less, and your Galactus will come out.
Oh! I really was hoping
not right.
For the Galactus.
It's not right for Galactus yet.
Zombie Galactus. All right.
Rebel turn.
Step aside. Yes.
The shark's back.
All right.
Sharky's back in sound, kids. Everybody clear out.
I think I got nudged. I think I was right here, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
Does this come out? No, please, keep doing your turn. We're just gonna
molest my shark suit. I see how it is. I see how it is.
Just the
right. So there's a dude face that I don't have.
Yep.
So I should spend an action to. So I'm not actually.
It's not gonna stop. Now you know what it's like
really
to be a shark.
Not.
Oh, did we
right?
Roll a one?
Get tagged, getting caged and stuff.
Okay. Anyway.
So I don't actually collect them. I have to like push them with the cards, right?
I was like, this many? No.
So when you play a card, you can move them.
How many fingers is D20?
So it's like pushing them as opposed to
like,
flying
hey,
over, scooping
right.
them
up, the table.
Right. flying them. So.
Right.
Okay.
When you
what happens if I push them onto a spot that the
nothing happens?
So it's fine.
It just makes it easy.
You do want to get them to your home base.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So,
this is that Game of Thrones. Is that tense?
It's gotta beat them.
Right. So we determined that a boost only means that I draw more than one card, or it means that I can move it more.
Oh
than
yeah,
one.
Shark play is
a,
not consent.
A boost can be used to draw a card or as an action.
You're right. You're right.
The double boost can be used to augment a move.
You
so I would play.
You would get three moves if you played a card and a double boost.
Do it.
I can do that.
Okay.
Okay. So
bullshit.
Put your money where your mouth is.
Well, I'm trying. It's just very hard without opposable thumbs. Okay.
You can fix. Brought this on yourself.
Okay.
Extra.
So move double boost.
Cut your arms off.
I am an entertainer.
Are you not entertained?
So you can move.
It's all right.
All Kriegers.
So I would want to move him
one,
here
two,
because then no. Oh. You're going the long way. One.
Oh right.
Two. Done.
Yes.
Because
he knows that Westeros map.
River whatever. So he's mine.
Mm-hmm.
If you can get him.
Dangerous up by the wall. I don't know how far you want to go up there.
Yep.
And
you can move now.
You can move all the other Kriegers.
These as well.
Oh, just a quick question. If there's
can I move me instead,
tokens
though?
Tokens on a spot. Can we kill both of them?
So you've played an action.
Oh.
We'll say yeah.
Yeah, we'll say yeah.
You have played an action to move these guys. So
okay.
You're still taking the action. As part of that action, you can still be moving them. You can move all of them at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Weedy.
And then
you can move them three.
I can.
Hello, more puns. Anna gives the fin ear.
Okay, so that was your first action. Now you have two more cards left.
Are you at three now? Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, revealing that base may have been
so
tricky.
Yeah.
Especially that closer to home.
Right.
It's interesting now though, because
if I did that in this case, they all had, all three had to be the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
So
the same head face. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So like I couldn't use one to move and then two to move the heads. Like it's not three actions that I get out of that.
Correct.
It's three of the same.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely.
That's really annoying.
So the interesting thing here though is that so she has these one more unique head to mm-hmm. to win. Remember, there's four of these are blanks. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So and now she's back home and she's far from
that's true
where she needs to go. So.
The next one's gonna be hard to get.
It's gonna take a few turns.
Yeah.
And you guys could still potentially roll Galactus and then start just
yeah,
burning.
Y'all should just go.
I wanna burn it
like
to the ground!
Three times again.
Yep.
Ego boost, ego double boost. I go one. Well, actually, I'm gonna go one, two, three.
Okay.
And the heck out of there.
And y'all should just
so now
shoot all these heads.
We're gonna shuffle this.
Because he said I could shoot both of those, I'm gonna use three actions.
Kill them and feed them to Galactus!
No eating sharks!
Otherwise, it's spend one action kill, spend one action, spend one action to get there.
Unless they're humanely farmed or something.
I mean, it's just way later.
Yeah.
Well, you can do that?
Yeah.
But we decided to collect.
I want to
do it.
And
I do
kills
it.
One.
Totally dance if somebody donates.
Yeah, I just confirmed with them.
We've had a region.
Nice. Okay. Alright.
We had $25.
Okay. Yeah. Let's do it. Okay. Mm-hmm. One. Can I kill them both?
We are.
I told them yes.
Oh, they said yes.
Yeah! Do it!
They're kind of behind, so I was like, yeah.
Who's getting the cheat now?
Yeah. No, this is bullshit. Let's go.
Yeah.
Buffet bitches!
Feeding them to zombie Galactus. Okay.
Alright, so we're shuffling.
So now I want to move.
We're shuffling your deck back in.
Totally cheating.
One over.
Should I move this way or that way?
Well, because like the easy kills are over here and then you can see.
Yeah, okay. So one to move to here.
Shuffle it around.
Oops. Hello, you live here. And then one to eat her. And then.
So I totally missed how you're cheating?
When they come,
they...
Well, oh,
when they,
really?
So when they attack,
yeah,
they attack
right.
All of the heads that are in
now. Oh wait, so then do I get that one too?
I guess.
If this is a whole one big thing?
No.
No,
no, no,
I mean like border, like,
state
here.
Oh,
these
region.
Two are in one
region.
There's a lot of stuff in there now.
Okay.
We made it
doing
more
it.
Difficult because you know, that's 75%.
Boom! So essentially you turned on easy mode for them is what you're saying.
No,
they're still very far behind.
Yeah. Because this just
so
means
you turned on easy mode. I get it.
A little bit.
No. This increases their chances to bring out
the Galactus.
It's
the 8th place Mario Kart mechanic.
I would really
exactly.
like to see this
blue
Galactic
Galactus.
So you turned
right?
on easy mode.
Galactus.
So I spent
Zombie
three
Galactus
to
mechanic.
Eat two Lannis.
Those are the words.
But you only need two. Right? Because you move and then eat.
One, two,
oh,
three.
Oh, okay. My mistake. Gotcha.
And then I got like one more action, which I guess I'll just guard over here.
So now I have to roll a 10?
Alright.
Okay,
wait,
let me, like,
6, 7, 8, 9.
So
good luck.
Eight, right.
Okay.
Good luck. You got this? Okay.
Good luck. Power of the right shark!
Woo!
Oh!
Right shark, why you gotta do us like that?
Fine. You know what, next time, chat, if you ever see a shark that's beached, you throw that bitch right back in the ocean and say, not today, evolution.
Not today. All right.
Excuse me.
Shark's turn.
Blank one.
Blank.
Do you want to check that for me?
Yeah, it's blank. Okay.
Please.
I'm the shark! Are you trying to intimidate me with my theme music? What are you doing?
Real tense moment.
I feel the tension. What's gonna happen? What a standoff!
Me.
Tune in next week!
Might be bro. Dunna.
Six.
Oh!
Oh!
Okay, Cheryl, so Cheryl,
Cheryl. Cheryl.
Do I have Cheryl, to Carol. Use all of my cards this turn?
You want to. Why would you not want to?
I mean, should double boost maybe? Maybe not?
So close.
Or maybe she's overly confident.
So where do these go? Here?
Next turn?
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they just go in every spot that's adjacent to
I would say
this region. So I put one there. And then put one around. But I think there's five tops, so.
But that's just so that you're guaranteed to.
That one's on adjacent. Right, this one is, though.
Mm-hmm. And so you can't.
Oh, no, so this one is.
Specific moments that you need.
Westeros. These don't really not have very strong confusing combos.
Okay. Right.
Does we're gonna qualify as adjacent to there.
Okay. There's only so many.
I'm asking if this qualifies as adjacent to here.
This is how you make design decisions. So you get to keep it.
You get to keep it. So you can just draw three more.
Cool. That's not yet. It's banking not my turn.
That card.
Okay.
Nice.
It's the end of your turn. You draw back up at the end of your turn.
I'm clearing these guys up.
That way you can plan in between turns.
Each.
Are you laughing at my pins?
I just love it. Then I'm gonna. Should I move
I am
up
determined.
To here? Yeah, I'm doing it.
I just want like little mini sharks.
I'm moving here.
I want like googly eyes right here, and so it looks like there's little sharks in your hands. Oh, that would be amazing.
And then I'm gonna.
It's like a shark face.
Shark hands?
Yes.
On a shark.
Here.
Yes, I love it.
Oh, I have made my moves.
So...
I like this game.
And then you have little fins
too.
Yoink.
Yep.
Another two.
Yep.
Oh, gosh.
Oh,
every
option.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
12 or less.
Man, come on.
I think it's coming out.
Yeah, all right. Sorry. You're going to have to show up next week when I actually use Galactus.
You can tune in next week to see how this will
happen. Oh, okay. Yes. We have a Galactus. Cool.
All right,
what happens now?
He doesn't do anything.
Galactus.
So you have to roll a d8. So wait, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Roll a 1. You need a 1 right now.
Yeah.
You really need a 1 right
now.
No
one ever says to roll low, but...
You need a 1 right now.
You're cursing it!
God damn it.
Yeah!
This thing is ridiculous. Come on. All right, so then this... All of this, right?
Yes, no, move the Galactus. Come on, you guys gotta do it.
Where do I put it? Where do I put it?
Easy mode.
Right.
Boom!
Yes.
Boom.
On easy mode.
Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Get out
but now he goes off. Back.
Bye. That was. Oh, these guys waited 2 hours for that to happen.
So you got one.
Awesome. Yeah.
You got one.
That was awesome.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
We
You're
got
kind
one.
Of in the middle.
All right.
Should he not stay out?
No.
I think we're having him come out. He just comes
boom and goes
he just goes boom.
But there's a good chance that he'll come out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This is fun.
Yes.
If it wasn't for that one, I think you would have lost next turn.
Yeah, actually.
But I did it!
Holy crap,
because I got magic fingers!
No quadruple boost?
No quadruple boost. No quadruple boost. What is this? Insanity?
What, they get easy mode?
This
game is
ridiculous.
It's fine. See how it is? It's fine.
No, it is. It is a quadruple boost. She's using that one. Move two, and then she has a double boost, which gives her two more points. So it's not quadruple boost, it's just four movement points.
Four movement.
Thanks, small friend.
Four movement. Thank you very much.
Where are you gonna go?
All the way across the board again.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. This is like all one freaking thing here.
Yeah, it's kind of a mess.
It ends like right there.
Yeah.
Ha ha!
Four.
I'm trying to fix it now.
Surprisingly balanced.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, guys.
5 and 6 gets me here, and this flipped, which is blank. That's okay. I can manage this.
Yes.
I still got this.
All right.
Okay.
Still got this.
Next, I'm gonna play 1. Go here. Right. 2. Secret peek. It's just one to flip that over.
It's free.
Like,
you can
for me, it's
yep. You looked at it, now you can reveal it.
Boom, free. So, Cyril.
So she revealed
so just
it. Cyril
Figgis.
Yeah,
right?
Just
sweep
it out.
It's just
okay.
Two.
Here and here.
Oh.
3 total.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wait. No. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay. So one of hers is to look, and then she may reveal.
Sorry, what was the fourth one?
So she's decided to
every spot is adjacent.
I'm guessing they're going to try to attack them.
So because I was on here, can I just
but then it does, yeah.
Pick it up with one?
Yeah.
Sure.
And then I'll spend another one to move there.
Oh, you were on the far one?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm sorry. It should have been like that then.
So it's only two, right?
Yeah, I thought you were there when you revealed. So you ate one, and then you move there, and did you have an extra one?
Yeah.
Does she have an extra action?
I don't think so.
Let's do it again.
She ate one and then
killed
it. Move, reveal.
Because she moved kill, over, move. Reveal.
No,
she,
there's one left. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I have one card left?
No,
you use all your
zero cards.
Yes.
Okay.
So the thing here now is if you get Cyril Figgis to the base, you win.
Yes. Spot she's at.
But,
so she's coming in from this way.
Do I have to be adjacent to it to move it?
No. It's still her turn.
No.
And they get to do
this. This is dramatic.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
But it's random.
So. It's true. Yeah. Hop from here to here.
And.
Right there.
I'm not feeling good about this.
How many do we have now? We should
have lots. It's probably a guaranteed hit.
Yeah, it's a guaranteed
hit.
1, 2, 3, 4.
But he could appear in a place that there is no one.
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
So 17 or less.
Don't roll a 20.
All right.
Okay.
Galactus
comes out. Galactus
comes out.
Your turn.
Roll the count again. 1, 2.
Wait.
You got this.
What do I need?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
So 17 or less.
17 or
less. Don't roll a 20.
All right.
Okay.
Galactus comes out.
Your turn.
Roll the count again. 1, 2.
Wait.
You got this.
What do I need?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
And I want to drop them there. 1.
Ah. Nom.
All right.
Okay.
The game is starting to get as tense as the music is.
Yeah.
I think we're all just surprised that this is, oh my god, it's kind of working.
I'm actually having fun.
Yeah, I know.
That so, is even more important.
Yeah. Sometimes these games are not fun. Yeah. This is actually fun.
Okay, cool.
Right.
Now that I've gotten the hang of it.
We'll get an extra
action.
No, I already did.
Yeah, but you can use the boost to buy a paint.
Because it helps that we've done a lot of playtesting and how to make stuff on the fly.
Yeah.
Did you tell them about how you guys...
Yeah,
we told them about
playing
with
Wes,
and some of
them
in the chat.
So, I'm just gonna spend them
that's
all
awesome.
On...
Yeah.
Chris
has made
games
on the fly, and so
what?
It's like, made for him.
Yeah.
Are you
moving Cyril?
Cyril Figgis.
No, it was the plan.
Okay.
Well, Cyril.
So,
I don't like
Cyril's
going.
2, 3, 4. Making a break for it?
Well, yeah, there he goes.
Yeah, I think we'll go to Silver Hill instead, but 1, 2, 3, actually.
Hey!
Alright, why not?
Is that a real question? Do you want to tell you why
two,
not?
2, 3, well, they're cheating. I might as well have some inside information.
We got a pre ball.
We got a pre ball. We were told to do it. Mm-hmm.
You can't save him.
Yeah.
So if you put him close to where they're at,
they're going to be able to kill him.
So yeah, we can come up.
They, that's right, because they can use an action to kill him. Got it. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. So there is the best I can do. That's
and so that means.
It's on you.
Now what happens if I don't have enough cards for a full hand?
You can do it. You can do it.
Shuffle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you'll get all those, and you'll draw two.
Are there any characters that haven't been revealed?
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh?
Yeah.
I think it's the mom.
Which is why I almost didn't.
Okay. Well, I'll just
keep revealing. Someone wants to see a mashup of endemic
four. Can I protect it?
Oh. You cannot protect it.
No. I'm gonna pretend to.
Okay.
Oh, I'm gonna move there.
You should have saved
You're right.
Mulligan?
Nope. I've made a huge mistake.
Yeah. This far.
Yeah, I should have come over here.
You're right.
And then that way if she reveals something.
I should have strategized.
Because I was going there anyway.
Okay, well, your turn.
I don't know how you don't know all the intricate strategies of this game.
I know.
It was invented hours ago.
1, 2, 3, and 4 to kill him.
Do it!
So that one, so this one should be added to your...
Okay.
And you're halfway to victory. You still need to save one.
Under 18. I don't think it's gonna happen.
I don't think so.
Okay, now we roll, right? How many?
Under 18, because we move this guy here. Unless we count these two.
Three?
Yeah,
three. So
we'll roll that d8 and we'll see where Galactus lands.
This is your lucky one.
Make it high.
Three.
Three.
Where?
Blue.
The blue section.
So one.
So we can just grab. Mm-hmm. Boom.
Yeah. It's a one day.
The glass is
19. So this has been revealed, so we can remove this because it's just throwing everybody off.
Oh. Yeah. So Galactus came out. It destroyed Lana. That was in the blue section.
Lana.
It should be
poor Lana.
You have a boost.
You said don't do that.
You said don't, but I'm thinking I'm gonna do.
So,
Lana.
You need to try to flip two over. So whatever way you can try to.
Which can't be done in one turn.
It's possible. I mean, it depends on if you. I don't know if you have boosts. Because if you can go one, two, three,
I have
four,
a regular boost, but not a double boost.
You would need
so
one.
That doesn't do anything.
Yeah, you would need. Yeah, you would need.
But you could reveal this one farther away, but then they'll take them a while to get over this, right? Mm-hmm. They give them some busy work and try to move the other ones.
Alright. So what I am going to do is I'm going to spend all of them to go here, reveal this one, then go here.
Okay.
Hold that pose in the start. Yes! Evil shark in the game.
Alright, so three. That is.
Zero.
Wait, he was already out. His head's here.
Was it
no, no, this is a three. This is a five.
Yeah, that
yep, that's her.
Okay.
So the silver haired fox. I don't think so.
So when that reveals, I shouldn't.
How many?
You might want to use that last move to move your people.
So I don't actually want to move here on the last one.
Yeah.
And then here?
Every spot that's adjacent.
Here.
Take this out.
Here. Here.
Yeah, and there too.
Yeah. New favorite
so
break room game.
Here.
You
need
to roll a 7 on Galactus and just stomp that bit.
Boom.
And so
let's
I guess I can move. I can spend the last card to move all of them.
Yes. That one's going to there.
Oh, that's how you get ants, man.
That's how you get ants. Dan, this game's closer than I thought it was going
to
be.
Yeah, I think the first three are pretty easy to get, and then after that it changes drastically.
Mm-hmm. Should I go for it?
It really, so if this is further developed, it really had the placement, starting placement of them would really matter.
Yeah, a lot.
Right, right, like none of the near the,
Here, let's play through this. One, two, three.
It gets us to 20.
And then here? Or here?
Whatever we want to move closer. So she can go toward the base.
That's my turn.
Alright.
I feel good about it.
Duuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuuu
Joe, can you ready my victory music, please?
No, Joe, ready mine.
And Galactus, we have to roll anything under a 20.
Do it.
17.
You got this.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So, one, a 7 or a 4?
You need a, yeah, I would, you need a 4 is what I think you need.
4, 5. That's one, not two, what three. I wanted.
There
four.
Is no stopping
five?
Me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's this one.
Ah.
That was super not what I wanted.
Aw. Womp womp.
Now is the time when you lose.
I will throw you back in the ocean.
Set me free.
Alright, so.
Raise many Russian shark babies?
Yes.
Make them strong.
So, in short, all I have to do is move one of them one, mm-hmm. two, three, and four, right?
Yep.
I just need to move one of them four. And I'm pretty sure I can do that with just those two cards. With just these two cards. With only half of my hand, I win.
Wow. Because you got some swagging on
boosts in there, is what it was?
Hmm? What was that?
She had a cam and a double boost.
Okay.
Oh, did you win?
Did you just do it?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, shark one.
This isn't even my final four.
One, two, three, four. Just enough.
Very close. Very
four
close.
Four, two. I was supposed to have the boosts. We're definitely relevant in that one.
Yeah, there you go. Danger Thrones.
Danger Thrones. We entered into a very dangerous throne.
Do y'all, as players and designers, have any kind of game notes after playing through?
Don't wear the shark suit.
Don't wear the shark suit. Okay.
Once I came into it and started playing it, it made more sense for me.
Yeah. It seems very complicated at first.
It was like, here's 10,000 things, but actually this was really satisfying.
Goodness. Yeah.
Wiping pens off the board is fun.
Yeah, I really liked it actually. I think it's really fun having the two versus one.
Just get behind going.
Also, we were better than anyone in the Empire because we actually hit our marks.
There you go.
Danger Throne.
What?
Yeah, I thought the thing I like about it that I think is encouraging, at least from my perspective, is the fact that you both felt like there was highs and lows.
Yeah.
Like there was times when you like felt like you're in charge and like no.
Yeah.
And I think in a game like this where you have that tug of war, you want that feeling. Like the worst case scenario would have been like if you never felt you had a like a fighting chance.
Yeah.
Or someone just like steamrolled the entire way, right?
So,
and it always
So balancing and figuring out the starting placement of things, you know, there might be a different ratio of blanks to hits and those types of stuff.
Like we actually had a chance.
We're like, boom, get that spot. There are two there. Definitely go for that one.
Still something Galactus, but still miserable.
I feel like this was like a big hit and have Galactus not landed there, then you lost a long time.
Absolutely.
Galactus did miss a lot too, so that randomness there is an interesting.
Yeah, so there's something to think about there, and it becomes when you have an element that is that swingy, you know, it can be sort of anticlimactic in a sense, even though it's like this big, huge thing. Like, if they win because of a Galactus, you know, 1 in 8 chance or whatever, like that doesn't necessarily feel good.
Right.
So I think the Galactus mechanic would need to be sort of dealt with. I like the idea that there is some possible way of these players, once Galactus is out, of expending resources to move him.
Yeah.
That might make.
Yeah,
maybe
cool.
A little more satisfying.
Or you could make this like obviously not as crazy. Like as you move him, like maybe a certain amount of these will go away.
Yeah, your full stats
like,
or something.
Yeah, so
something.
You still have them all under possibility.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe like the number that you roll from the D8 is going to subtract.
Makes sense.
So
makes
but overall, I had fun.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Yeah, nicely
done,
guys.
That was bad. Thank you. That's more. Yeah,
I was like,
I love it when people actually have fun.
The only thing that hasn't been mentioned already is when you've got one of the tokens on a peninsula, and it's only going to appear on one, but on like one or two spots, then that's a bit of an issue.
Yes.
But if you have enough out there, then
it's something that
it's a balancing thing.
You know, when we did it our last test, when we did the design session, we had it so that the teams were taking turns placing the tokens where they wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that some element of that would be welcome in this game. It does get a little bit hairy when you have these areas so close to the home base.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think that in a developed version, you'd have a little bit more of a buffer zone, a little more of a neutral zone, but then still have that ability for players at setup to influence where the tokens are going.
And not just play, because when we had started playing it, it was just a game of keep away. So after it got to this point, you know, of course you would just want to be like, I'm going to move it, you know, over there, further away from you. And we just have to find a balance. But
even possibly setting it up so that you start across the board from your base. Because then you have to, you can't just
you
do what I did, which was in a few moves, I got 3/4 of what I needed, and then it took the rest of the game for me to finish it up.
Yeah,
or maybe like one
start.
Starts here, one starts there, that kind of thing.
It would make it a much longer game, too.
Even if the, you know, the TIE fighters start there, but the Rebel starts farther away.
Yeah.
Right.
And so that would be compelling.
Yeah.
Okay.
But overall,
you can roll a dice for your start area is where the base is.
We did it!
Well done. Thank you all very, very much.
Yeah, thanks for coming on. Do you guys want to plug us again before we close out the show?
Oh, yeah. My name is Chris Rollins. I work at Card Kingdom and Mox Boarding House in the Seattle area. I host the Tabletop Games podcast called NPC Cast. You can go to npccast.com to see or to hear me there, I guess. I also have a YouTube channel called 1000XP, spell it out. So it's youtube.com/1000XP. I do game design videos, all sorts of different stuff about getting into game design and getting inspired to design games. It's kind of what I'm about. Yeah, that's me.
Once again, I'm Nicole Jekic. You can read my reviews and Luke's reviews, who's my partner who works on acrosstheboardgames.net. So we review a lot of Kickstarter games, fun games like this. We also do some design things for that as well. We're also going to be at a Playtest Northwest around Seattle. So I host an event every third Sunday, 2 to 6 p.m. at Reagan Lounge. So if you ever want to play test games, you can do that. Or you can just go to Playtest Northwest and find, or playtestnorthwest.com and then find all the events in the Seattle and Portland area.
My name's Isaias Vallejo. I'm with Daily Magic Games. I just want to plug Playtest Northwest. So if you're interested in designing something or just want to show it to somebody, I think that's the best avenue to go about. There's a lot of open people. They're willing to give your game a try. They're willing to give you feedback. And that's what we like to do. We like to play prototypes and break them and make them better. That's the tagline, actually, building better games. Nice. So yeah, playtestnorthwest.com. Check it out.
Next convention we're going to do is in Portland. It's PDX Age. So that's coming up in a couple weeks.
Oh, and then we're at ETX. Oh, so we have a design contest going on right now. So if you're an unpublished designer, it's the Northwest Lucy Award with ETX, with Uncle's Games. So design a game. Get it in there. Yeah. It'll be judged by real designers.
And it's for unpublished game designers specifically, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Cool. Well, thanks y'all for joining us on another episode of Grab Bag. We made a game this time.
It was good.
It was a crazy game. It was.
I liked it.
It worked. Thanks for watching another episode with us. What's the next? Zach with Paragon.
Zach and Joe are going to be playing Paragon. We're also going to be giving away a Founder's Key during that time, so maybe you should pop in and play.
So stick around for that. And with that, Joe, wrap us up.
Shut it down, Joe.
Shut it down.
Shut it down.